Oracle Television heralds a new era in psychic and spiritual programming, bringing you online interactive programs and services that enable you to connect with practitioners who have expertise, authenticity, and integrity. Watch our programs live on our website, along with previous programs, and read news of upcoming events. You can also watch us on Facebook as we stream live to our Facebook page.
We're going today because I was really drawn to this side of the room.
Oracle Television also offers pay-per-view tutorial videos from your favourite psychics and practitioners who are happy to share their knowledge and expertise with you. Get involved with our live interactive shows, which showcase leading psychics, readers, astrologers, and mediums, and offer you free readings live on air. You can also book private appointments with our featured guests and enjoy a one-to-one reading over the telephone at a time that suits you. Good evening and welcome to Psychic Oracle Live. My name is Carrie Kirkpatrick and I am joined by an old friend in the studio today, somebody who I've worked with before on two psychic shows over the years. I'm joined by the incredible psychic medium, Tracy Baker.
Hi, Carrie.
Hello, Tracy. It's so lovely to see you here.
It's lovely to be here.
I know. So our paths have intertwined over the years,
again,
haven't they?
Yes.
Yes. And Tracy has been involved with Psychic Oracle when we've done live events as well. And, you know, has always stayed in touch. I mean, you don't live really that close to us, so we really appreciate you coming down to the studio today.
Well, it's nice to be invited.
Good. You're very welcome.
So, and,
you know, hope you come back again as well.
Well, I will. Absolutely. Why
so, Tracy,
not?
Tell us a little bit, for those viewers who haven't seen you work before or maybe haven't seen you on the screen for a few years, can you tell us a little bit about how you work in the psychic and spiritual field?
Well, I work, really, I don't like to think of myself as constantly tuned in, but what I'm told is I'm naturally intuitive.
Yeah.
So even though I'm not always ready to give readings for people, I'm naturally intuitive, and that's how I started. Even the people would go, no, you're wrong. I would know that I'm not wrong.
Yeah.
If I knew something wasn't going to happen, I'd go, that's not going to happen. Even before I started working spiritually, and the odds were, like, very much stacked against it, but 9 times out of 10, it wouldn't happen. And that's how I started, and that's how I work, on instinct, on gut feeling. I do use cards, but I instinctively know whether something's likely to happen or not.
Yeah. And do you get messages from spirit for people as well? Does that come into your kind of remit of skills?
Well, I always think with things like that, sometimes it's not easy to just command spirit. I mean, at the end of the day, I work for them, not the other way around. And I always think if anybody wishes to communicate through me to somebody, then I will. But I will never go, oh, yes, I can get a loved one who's passed over at the drop of a hat, because that really isn't how it works. But yes, I can pass messages over from people's loved ones who've passed over.
So do you do you tend to do platform demonstrations, or you just focus more on the one-to-one scenario?
I have done platform work in the past. With regards to mediumship, I do find it easier to just give short messages rather than a long mediumship reading. I think to sustain a mediumship reading for 1 hour for one person with one reading would actually be quite hard, and I find it easier to just give messages. So that's where the platform work comes in. To just, you know that you've got somebody's loved one who's passed over and just give a message. That's really, it's also got to be absolutely spot on to them and not general. Yeah. In order to be effective with mediumship, it really can't be general.
No.
It's quite hard to do. Yeah. Something that I can do, but it's got to be specific.
Yeah. So really, I know that you have a lot of regular clients that come to you again and again, and it's not as if you're saying to them, you've got to speak to me every week, but people do always come back, don't they? And why do you think that is?
Well, that's how I get my work, to be honest. I don't advertise. In the grand scheme of things, I don't pay for advertising. I do have a lot of repeat clients, and I think it's because, you know, I get testimonials and that and recommendations. And I think I'm not very good at self-promotion, I'm afraid. It's usually
where we come in.
I'm not very good at self-promotion. It's usually because something has come to pass, and in particular, something that they really didn't think would.
Yes.
And it has. And, you know, that goes back to, you know, things like, well, I never really... When you said that, to be honest, Tracy, I really thought, oh, she's having an off day.
Mm.
Well, never mind, you know. But, and then they said, when it happened, I nearly died. You know, they were just really...
Yeah.
You know, and that's how I get my clients.
Now, we have been having a bit of a chuckle in the studio already, haven't you? Because you are rather known for your humour, isn't
it? I know.
You had me in fits earlier on.
Well, no, but I've been punched in the face on arrival, which really, I wasn't expecting that.
It was an accident on his girlfriend.
Punched me in the face and right, an uppercut.
I was trying to sort her microphone out of my...
He just went, punch me in the face. And I
it
thought,
was
well,
an accident, honest,
what
honest
a greeting.
Your
what a greeting, punched in the face. On arrival, an hour and a half to get here, and she punches me in the face. What about that?
And I'm still crying with laughter. It sounds really bad, but it's just
I'll come here again.
She'll get her own back in the break, I'm sure.
If we can have a fight in the break.
We can stream that live, and speak too soon. Now, what we're going to be doing tonight is we're going to be inviting people to send their questions in, and we've had a few questions sent in already. Also, at 8 o'clock, we're going to be getting a client on the phone and putting her on speaker. We're going to use, I'll probably just use this microphone and put it literally, because we haven't got any new phone technology that's going to help us to pipe through the phone call directly over the airwaves, I'm afraid. So what I thought I'd do is get it on speaker, just put my microphone next to it. I thought that'll work.
Well, hopefully.
Yeah. And we've got the lovely Alison, and she's a Cancerian, and we're going to be having her live on the phone, and you're going to be doing a reading for her, and I might do a bit of a reading for her as well.
Okay.
But I thought what I might do is just to get the ball rolling. Just before, about an hour or two ago, I was on Facebook and I had this lovely message through from a lady called Vibrational Healing. And she works, she's Debbie Anderson. She goes under the name Vibrational Healing. She works out in Canada.
Oh, right.
And bless her, what had happened is I'd put the Facebook post in about click here onto our Facebook page. And I'd accidentally put a space in between Oracle and television. And what had happened is Facebook had latched onto the word Oracle and not the word television. So initially, people were clicking onto it and going through to that computer software company.
I know.
So thank you to Debbie Anderson for actually pointing it out really swiftly. So I was able to go back and edit it all before people clicked on it.
Oh.
But we ended up having a conversation over Facebook. And she said that she would try and tune in, even though she's in Canada and a very different time zone. And she's also a medium. So I said, we'll give you a reading on the show. And she's a Taurian.
Right.
And so I said, we'd give her a little reading. And then, bless her, she gave me a message from two of my relatives in spirit
as well. That's good, isn't it?
I know. So it was just really lovely. It was really charming and very well-received message and really lovely. And I just came away from that feeling so touched that... You know, we're able to do that with the technology and with the social media and with the groups that we're a part of, and that we can send these messages around the world, and how normal we think it is. But in fact, if you stand back to think about it, it is absolutely mind-blowing that we can do that. Here we are in London, and Debbie is now part of our show all the way over in Canada.
Yeah, excellent.
You know,
I think the thing is as well, with regard to things like that, when we hear a story like that, social media, sometimes there's a very negative aspect of social media. And I think it's quite nice, if it's used properly, how it can be used for really good, you know, to make good connections, good, you know, get involved with other people, like-minded people. So it does have really positive. Yeah. And the Oracle without the television, they haven't answered my questions, have they? Have they had my messages, my emails, my texts? Because I don't want them answering my questions.
No, no, we'll be very put out. Well, when I registered the name Oracle Television Limited, I was immediately approached by their lawyers to say that I wouldn't be attempting to duplicate their business. So I don't know whether this will become a legal incident.
I don't like it. Well, we'll see if the justice card comes out, shall we?
Now, Tracy, Debbie, Taurian, shall we start tuning in for her?
Yes,
give her a little reading.
I know she's a Taurian, but what actually is her date of birth?
I can tell you that in just a moment.
Okay.
Are you able to, if I could just ask my assistant to go onto the Facebook page there into messages... Facebook is open over there, and then I think we'll be able to find that exactly for you.
Right,
I thought I'd get away.
I'm just going to do a number.
Yeah,
you know,
unless
maybe.
I can get it up on here. We should do it.
Just
we
thought I'd
it
make
for
it a bit more
a
awkward.
Yeah.
In light of the fact I've been hit.
She did give me the whole birth date, and I couldn't remember it when I came upstairs. So let's just see.
They
would
be telling you I can't
first.
Add up until
it's
you
in
actually
messages,
told me.
It's in messages.
And if anybody can add up quicker, then that would be brilliant, because I'm not very good. If I need to do up to 20, I'll have to take my shoes off.
Right, well, we're just seeing how quickly we can get it up there.
Matron. Sorry.
Vibrational energy. It's going to be one of those nights, isn't it? It's all carry-on psychic. Carry-on up the psychic.
Carry-on up the psychic. That's
carry
another
on
one.
The
you
psychic.
Can't help it, can you? Really.
Okay, have we got the date of birth? 26th of April 1957. 26th of April 1957.
So I've got to try and add that up. So I've got the two. Could somebody add this up for me, please? That's a little bit more.
All right, 26th of April, 1957. So what we need... this is very complicated, Tracy.
It is, and I do beg your pardon.
Right, so what do you need us to do? We're going to make a little note here.
Well, you've got to add the two, the six, the four.
The two plus six.
Plus four.
Six plus four.
Plus one.
Plus one.
Plus nine.
Plus nine.
And what was the year?
57.
Plus five, plus seven. How many did that come to,
34.
Please?
34.
Right, so that's seven.
That's a seven.
Right, now that's good. I'm a seven. How funny is that? Poor woman.
You don't look a day over six.
No, I don't look a day over six. I feel sorry for the lady now, because she's a seven. I'm a seven. I know exactly how things are with you. Right, so seven. Sometimes they're lacking in priority. We have to sort of maybe rein ourselves in and focus. We get taken away with ideas here, there and everywhere. And it's all about getting things in the right semblance of order and not going off, I call it going off on one. So much to do and so little time. And doing things you like will take precedence over doing what you actually need to do. And sometimes that's got to be stopped, if you like. Sometimes I feel also own worst enemy springs to mind as well, which is not going to serve you. But I'm just going to put some cards out here. There's a very good decision going your way. I feel it involves a gentleman, and I feel it involves work, money, and finding peace. Definitely work. The Eight of Pentacles there speaks of work, and it speaks of being very good at what you do. So I feel there's a decision coming up which completely goes your way on the work front. I don't know where the younger male is involved in this, but I want to say, you know, rise above all the challenges, rise above all the negativity, because the decision does definitely go in your favour. And it's also, to me, the world of spirit are involved. It wouldn't surprise me if it's not spiritual work or healing or something like that. Within the next 6 months, there's a great success coming in and around this. So I think that's something to really watch out for.
Well, I'm going to join in here as well, because Debbie was so lovely. And I'm going to start off. I've got a few different decks of cards with me here. And Tracy's already given you such a lovely, comprehensive reading there. But I'm going to start off. In fact, I'll ask Tracy to choose one. Could you select one goddess card for Debbie?
I like that one.
Lovely. Oh, Mary Magdalene, unconditional love. Isn't that beautiful? I don't know if we can see it. Oh, look, there we are. That put you. Daisy.
It's over there. It's her studio. I'm telling her where the camera is.
Sorry, Debbie, she's just going to get me in fits all night. She really is. Unconditional love. Love yourself, others, and every situation, no matter what the outward appearances may be. And we're just going to be giggles all night. Giggles all night. I can tell you I'm giggling with us there, Debbie. I'm crying with laughter with this lady. I'm actually crying. I'm also going to take something from the Magdalene deck, and we've got co-creation. Again, a lovely accent here on the image of the heart. And it's about working from the heart energy. And I do feel that there's a lot of healing of people's hearts. And I know from the brief kind of interaction that we had on Facebook earlier on that you are coming from a beautiful energetic space. And I called it vibrational healing earlier on. And in fact, it's not, it's vibrational energy. It's in her name, she goes by. But I feel that healing obviously coming very much in there with it, with your work with spirit. I'm also going to take one of these beautiful goddess cards for you, which are designed by the artist and hand-painted by this artist, Tiana. And look at that one. We've got this beautiful one that shows a kind of fiery image. And it's really about sort of, I feel, embracing the energy of fire, of transformation, transmutation. And it's about working with fire energy as a process of change, creation, change in your own sense of being, and a real sense of just kind of, I don't want to say, I want you to work with it energetically, work with it magically, but I don't feel in a kind of Wiccan way. I feel as though you're working with the energy of fire, maybe even anything from a candle flame for meditation through to even sort of just working with this image of fire, of going through the heat and fire of transformation. Working very much with cooking, working with very much with incense, anything that revolves around fire. A Denise Lynn card for you as well, and we've got Letting Go, which is very nice, and it shows the two fishes here letting go, and again, linking in very much into a Piscean time of year. So I would be looking at that being a quite a significant time of year for you. Even though you're Taurus, there's a sense of sort of a Piscean ability to go with the flow, and let go of old emotional situations and old emotional traumas. You're very good at working through things, but, you know, as is always the case, you might find there's just another level of letting go that needs to happen. And I want to say, I feel that there's an element of counselling that comes into the work that you do, even though you may not go by a counsellor as such as an official job title. The counselling side is going to be quite interesting for you, and you may even do a little bit more study and research into different things and suggestions and solutions that you can suggest for people after you've already given them the healing and the messages from spirit and many other different things. So for as is often the case with many of us working in the spiritual field, always expanding the skills, but this kind of trinity there of the healing, the messages from spirit and the counselling and solutions, which are kind of giving people a bit of grounding again afterwards. And I see a beautiful image of almost like a kind of a cabin, in log cabin, or somewhere by a river with a nice little sort of wooden footbridge nearby it. So it's near water, a river or a lake. And I don't feel that you need to live there, but you know, visit there. I know in Canada there are a lot of beautiful open spaces, very beautiful. But I feel that this is quite significant for you to have this affinity with a place like that. So it's either somewhere you're going to visit or somewhere you need to revisit.
Wow. Good.
Thank you so much for getting involved with the show, Debbie. And it's been a pleasure for us to read for you and to have the interaction with you all the way over in Canada.
I know. Lovely.
Very, very nice. So Tracy, can you tell me a little bit about the best way, you know, how do you like to start approaching your psychic work? You know, do you have a certain kind of ritual or procedures that you go through, you know, when you're kind of getting ready to do readings for people? Do you like, or do you're very spontaneous about
I won't, if I've got somebody coming to my house for a reading, or even a telephone reading, doesn't matter. Well, you know yourself, if you're going to do a face-to-face reading, you've got to get, like, all your table ready and mm-hmm. candles out and things like that. But even if it's just a telephone reading, people sort of see me sort of out and about. Yes, I am very sort of chatty, very sociable, very humorous, loud and vulgar on occasion. Can be, under the right circumstances. But when I've got to do a reading, I won't speak to anybody for an hour beforehand.
Really?
I won't have the radio on, I won't have the television on, I won't have anything. I wouldn't answer the phone unless it was life and death. So for sort of upwards of an hour before I'm actually getting ready to do a reading, I won't speak to anybody. I turn the telly off, radio off, phone on silent, and I just literally need peace. Yeah. In the warmer weather, I'll go outside. I mean, obviously not at the moment, it's dark and it's... But in the warmer weather, I will just go outside or sit on my front doorstep or just go sit, like, in the garden because I need silence in order to work
properly. Do you actually meditate during that time or are you just still?
I don't think I would call it meditating, but things do come into my head sometimes. I don't actually consciously meditate, but I do need that peace and quiet and silence. If somebody wants a full reading from me, I think that they deserve that clear mind. Yeah. Because, you know, we've all got lives, families, running here, there and everywhere. I don't think it's good to just, like, you know, run in, pick up the phone and do a reading. If it's I like to give my best and I like to get myself ready and... You know, you need silence. Yeah. If you've been stuck in a massive queue at the supermarket and you're all hyped up, you don't want to come straight back home and go, right, just you want your reading now then, because your head is still full of, like, the crying child in the queue and that needs to be cleared and then you can go in. And then I could do, like, 10 readings, but I would need that hour to have... Yeah. I need silence, strangely enough. So does everyone else that knows me. But whether they get it or not is another matter. But in answer to the question of needing doing a reading, I need silence beforehand.
Yeah. So coming back to sort of meditation and spirituality, you know, do you feel that your spiritual work has led you to a certain belief system, or did you sort of have a certain belief system that then led you to working with spirit and doing readings for people? Did you find perhaps your spiritual belief system was at odds with the work that you were doing? I mean, how do you feel about spirituality now?
I think that I feel about it is like this: it's got to have balance. I will never not be spiritual. It's as simple as that. But I do believe that you've got to have a work-life balance. And when I'm not... I've got to quote one of my friends, you know, how do you get in the zone then? You know, that's a zone. He calls it the zone, like that. And that's I'm just saying that.
Who says that?
It's someone that I know. Yeah, yeah. Just, you're going to get in the zone then and do any readings like that. It's just something. And I thought that's a good way of doing it. Somebody doesn't know anything about readings and doesn't understand, but calls it getting in the zone. And I thought that's a good way of describing it. There's never a point in my life when I won't be spiritual. But when I'm sort of not tuned in and working spiritually, I would never do anything that was unspiritual. But you've got to have the work-life balance in that. I do like to go out and enjoy myself. I do like a good laugh. I do like, you know, to go out and have fun. But that doesn't mean I'm not spiritual. Now, you get some people whose opinion is, if you've got a sense of humour, you can't be spiritual. You can't be, or you shouldn't say that, that's not spiritual. And I think, you know, some people can be too much completely. Yeah. Like, and I don't think that's a good way to be. That's just my opinion. There's got to be a balance. You've got to be, we are human.
Yeah.
We're not spirit.
Yeah.
We are absolute human beings with a spiritual pathway being walked.
Yeah.
So that's how
I agree with the humorous side of things, because Ernie James, who taught me a great deal, you know, was a partner of Marlene Sibley. He's sadly in spirit himself now, but he was very much one for working with the humour and teasing you and making you laugh and making those jokes. And he would use it actually as a way of getting through your barriers.
Yes.
and shifting the energy.
I think it lifts energy as
it
well.
It completely does lift the energy, and sometimes in the most difficult situations, you need to have that ability.
Yes.
See, he worked with me an awful lot after my mother had died.
Right.
And it was just his way. He would like kind of, you know, kind of pressure points and make a joke and do this and do that. And he had such a sense of humour, and it was quite slapstick in a way.
Yeah.
But, you know, sometimes it was really funny, and sometimes you just go, for God's sake, what are you doing? But in fact, what it really was doing was it was lifting your energy and breaking down those barriers and those kind of things where you would just freeze.
I just think there's people that think that they're confusing spirituality with being overly religious.
Yeah.
And it isn't the same thing.
Are you religious as well?
To be honest, yes. Yeah. But that's the difference.
But they're sort of separate. Do you see religion and spirituality separate?
Yeah, because I'm a believer, but you're a pagan.
Yeah, yeah.
So, but we're still spiritual.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I do believe in God.
Yeah.
You know, I put my hands up and go, yes, I do believe in God. Yeah. And obviously I believe in the afterlife. You're of a different belief.
Yeah.
But we're still both spiritual.
Yeah.
So they are different. There's your proof.
So you could almost like sort of make a difference between being spiritual as a kind of an approach to life, but being religious is identifying with a belief system.
But I'm not overly religious in that I don't force my beliefs on other people.
Yeah, yeah.
I wouldn't force readings or spirituality on other people.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't sort of force my, beliefs or anything on other people, because I think with religion and spirituality, everybody has got to find their own way and what works for them.
Yes.
And what brings them peace. Because ultimately, whether we want a relationship, a new job, a new car, a new house, live abroad, do this, do that, ultimately what we want is to be happy.
Yeah.
So that's what we should be asking for.
Yeah.
Because you could be getting it wrong thinking, oh, if I get a new car, I'll be happy.
Yeah.
Might not be.
Well,
the
when
car.
I teach people the cosmic ordering, I teach them to ask
to
for happiness
and
within
peace.
The wish.
Peace.
Because people forget.
Yeah.
They forget to ask to be happy.
To be happy.
Yeah.
Because that is the key. Peace and to be happy.
Mm.
It doesn't matter what brings that about, whether it's a new house, new partner, new car, new job. Ultimately, we all want to be happy.
Now, I'm going to ask you to do another reading now as well.
Mm-hmm.
There is somebody whose initial is A, who's an Aries, and they've got a big day on Tuesday.
Oh, okay.
And it might lead into your justice card. We'll wait and see. But it was just like there's a big event happening on Tuesday, and that, you know, I think the outcome of that will just... I know what the circumstances are, but I'm not going to tell you.
No, you mustn't tell me. See, that's another thing I don't like when people, they think you've found out beforehand.
Yeah.
You know, and things like that. And don't be ridiculous.
So
no,
it's Aries, initial A, and a big event on big day on Tuesday.
Oh. Actually, I'm just going to put that one there. There's the battle.
Mm.
There's the contretemps, as I call it.
So that's the Five of Wands that's come out, first of all.
Yeah, that to me, that always speaks of a bit of heightened energy, bit of competition, bit of a battle, the downside of that card. Because every card, I don't do reversals, every card's got a dark and a light side. That is, please don't enter into battle for argument's sake. That is like a more physical battle rather than a mental battle.
Mm.
And it's also being able to see off the competition. But if the competition needs seeing off, people just do it anyway sometimes, and not necessary. In this case, I feel it is. So now I'm going to have that anyway, because it wanted to come out. So here we've got here, somebody on their high horse. Now, between now and Tuesday, there's going to be like a new idea, new thought, something new is going to come into your head that's going to bring you... See, the Justice card is not there, but the Sun card is, which tells me out of heartbreak's going to come sunshine.
Oh.
I don't know where this comes in, but I feel like I've been ganged up on. I don't know if that makes any sense at all. I feel like I've been, like the need, somebody's tried to put my house in order where they didn't really, they shouldn't have done that. I feel like somebody's tried to, there is a need for order if you want the need for order in your own life, but I don't think anybody has got any right to try and put your house in order, which I feel has happened. That there's real heartbreak around this, to be honest, and mental anguish. But outside of that, out of that comes the Sun card, which is very, very positive. And I just want to say, be careful who you discuss all this with. I see you needing to maybe keep it to yourself. And you don't have to tell everybody everything. But, yeah, very positive outcome there with the Sun card. And when you've got Tuesday over, where the truth comes out, I don't want you to hang on to any, you know, once Tuesday's over, give yourself the rest of the week to process the negativity which has gone on and then let it go, never to be seen and repeated again.
Wow. Wow, that's amazing. I really like that. So I'm going to now take a couple of my other oracle cards as well. So I could have one each. Let's just choose one here for A.
For you.
From the Magdalene deck. Oh, that's beautiful. Look at that. We've got the card of decision. And this is lovely. It's showing a big full moon. And from the full moon, it shows it's almost like a huge drop of water, but it's sort of like the goddess as well, reflected off the water, this beautiful lunar energy. So that ties me very much into the full moons, working with the full moons, looking at the energy around the full moons. And even though there are all these squiggles that you maybe can't see very closely in the clouds, at first glance, they almost look like om signs to me. So I feel that this could be giving us a kind of a sense of finding peace through the energy of the full moon. I'm going to take a goddess card as well, and I've got Hathor, which is receptivity. Allow yourself to receive. This will increase your intuition, energy, and ability to give to others. So tuning into a very soft goddess of beauty and love and joy and music there. So this kind of energy overcoming it all. So not needing... And look at that revealing radiance. I really do think, A, that you're going to be shining as this... Not The Shining, the movie.
Is that the one where...
No,
not in that way.
Shining as in a beautiful pearl, yes. Revealing radiance. So you have to forgive us, A, for giggling away today. We're just in that mood tonight, aren't we, Tracy? And it says, my light illuminates the world. So I want to say that really with the combination of Hathor, the full moon, and this beautiful pearl, which also again links into another love goddess, Aphrodite, it's a sense about just revealing this beautiful energy. And you don't have to try too hard. You don't have to have a guard up. You don't have to be ready to fight your corner. It's just about just being there and like receiving all that beautiful spiritual energy and just radiating it. And if other people don't like it, then that's just tough.
Oh,
because
yeah,
that's what you're meant to do. And I'm going to take one more of these lovely goddess cards too. And look at that, even this one, we've got a goddess that's got beautiful hearts all over it. And that's a kind of a love goddess image. And the beautiful little hearts that Tiana's painted onto that card as well. And this is very much about embracing the love. I think it's the love goddesses coming in to heal you. That's three of those four cards have just really drawn me towards love goddess energy. And it's about the love within yourself, the love that are emanating and then drawing towards you the right kind of love in all areas of your life. And there, once that's all kind of settled and taken place, and there is no room for any negativity or any that might seek to tell you what to do or control.
We don't like that.
No, we don't. We're not
having
it.
We don't like that, do we, Carrie?
No,
we don't like those type of people, do we?
No. No, we don't. Now, Tracy, whereabouts do you live? You've travelled from outside of London to come in here today. Where do you live?
I've infiltrated the metropolis. I've come from sunny Milton Keynes.
Milton Keynes.
Yeah. Milton Keynes. I know. Obviously, not where I'm from initially, where I've seemed to have been living for the last 7 years.
Wow. I first met you, I was working in a psychic channel that was based up in Milton Keynes, and that's
Bletchley.
Bletchley. So when we
Home of the Codebreakers.
Home of the Codebreakers. Very, very nice. And then we worked in another incarnation of that psychic channel down in London didn't we?
I did used to come down to by the BT Tower.
Yeah, that's right.
Come and work there for sure.
That was a funny little studio,
wasn't
it? That was
funny, wasn't it? That building was...
It was a very eccentric building. If I could have shown you pictures of it. Because, you didn't really know what you were walking into. You sort of go into this sort of nondescript side entrance, and it was this very old-fashioned, almost like industrial building kind of environment where the steps were all concrete but very old, and everything was very cold, very sort of like Spartan kind of metal handrails. And then you'd come to these corridors, and they were just empty, and nothing was going on in these corridors at all, except you had doors. And they were like, you know, you thought maybe they were storage units, but inside of all of these doors and these endless corridors, that was very, very sort of run down, looked like it might have been some kind of club from the 90s in Old Street area or something. It's sort of very warehousey, run down. But there were all these little businesses going on. And of course, what I thought was really surreal was when I discovered that there was actually more than one channel broadcasting out of
there. Oh, there were loads.
Yeah, there was loads of channels broadcasting out of there. And we had a psychic channel in one little tiny room. Then we had all these adult sort of sex channels in another room. And then we had this sort of, I think there was
a
kind of
shopping channel.
There was a shopping channel. And then there was a sort of a Christian channel
that was a very strict Christian channel.
And wasn't there an Islamic one as well?
Yeah, there was all that in there.
And I just used to think, well, God help us if the fire alarm goes off and everyone's running out the corridors at the same time. It'd be like Benny Hill, wouldn't it?
It would have been funny.
Who would be chasing who? The psychics would be chasing the... And oh, no, we've got to chase the psychics. Then you have the women in their bikinis, or maybe not.
They'd have been being chased.
Yeah,
the ones on the adult channels.
They'd have been chased before, in this building that was so kind of nondescript that you just never would have believed it.
Yeah, it was a really, really old building.
It was, wasn't it?
Very old, with the cast iron rail.
Well,
absolutely.
It was haunted in the toilets.
Going way back, I don't know whether it would have been like an old hospital or an old asylum even.
Yeah.
Because that's
certainly
the
had
energy.
That feeling about it.
It wasn't doing badly for an asylum when we were all there, but I'm going back to, like, prior to that, you know, you got the old, like, asylums.
Yeah.
The hospitals, like, special hospitals 100 years ago. I always got the feeling in those corridors of, like, the old hospitals where you went in and didn't necessarily come out because you weren't really able to function properly.
Yeah.
People did get put away then, didn't they?
Yeah.
And that was the feeling that building had got. Oh. And that was before I got there.
Well, after you and I got there, I mean, there was just no hope
for
anything.
Well, that was the end of that, really.
Now, Tracy, I brought with me
today
into the studio this lovely scrying mirror. Have you ever worked with a scrying mirror before?
No, I haven't. I've got a crystal ball at home, but I've never actually worked with a scrying mirror.
Well, I just thought it might be nice to sort of bring that out today. My friend was here the other day, and she was looking at it, and you know, she was quite liking the idea of working with it too. So I thought, well, I'll bring it on the show tonight.
Yeah, why not?
Now, what we find here is that this is like sort of a polished black screen, and it's often used to be made out. You know, in some cases, they'd be made out of obsidian, or there would be concave glass, and they'd be painted on the back. And I feel this one is sort of like very old, and it's a painted one. But isn't that beautiful, the way that it's shining the light on there? And this was made by hand for Ernie James, who I mentioned earlier on, by John Wodge, I believe his name was. In fact, I'll turn it the other way up. And it's got this big carving on the back where it says King Leo. And he was a Leo, Ernie was a Leo. And this was handmade for him, using sort of beautifully, magically charged wood and blessed. And we have this lovely black scrying screen here. So do you want to just hold that for a minute and see what you feel from it?
I don't even know how to use these.
But it's just got a strong vibe to it, hasn't it?
Oh, yeah. It's really lovely.
Yeah. So what you can do is you can just kind of look at it. Obviously, we've got lights on in the studio, but you can sometimes sort of set up a scrying mirror with just like one candle and sort of just kind of gaze into it. Or I find them sometimes work a bit like an amplifier. So when you're tuning in clairvoyantly, you find it's almost
nice.
Like you've plugged into the grid.
Yeah, it's really nice.
And because obviously this was connected with Ernie, who taught me so much, who who's in spirit. And I can feel him around and going, great, you know. But he was northern as well.
Never. Which is the way you said great.
Great. correct.
Gave me a clue.
Don't leave Marley if you're watching. That's exactly what, great. That's what he used to say, and put his hands up like that. And he was from Newcastle area originally. And I feel that, you know, there's a great sense of humour and of kind of insight coming. In fact, many years ago when I was very young, I remember him predicting that people would be doing readings on TV.
Really?
And I just looked at him and I thought, you must be mad.
Oh.
I was like, really?
Well, it might have been, but he was right.
He was absolutely right. He said to me, he said, you know, they'll be doing this on TV. And I looked at him. Yeah, couldn't see it, you know.
No.
But then, of course, we know that we have had psychic channels now for 10 years, or variations of different ones that we've worked on. And here we are now. It's even gone one step further where you don't need to be on the Sky channels with all those restrictions. You can do this now on the internet.
Absolutely.
And just communicate directly with all of you, wherever you are in the world. So I thought it was really appropriate to bring out Ernie's scrying mirror today, you know, to help us to kind of get a bit of a link with him sort of tuning in today. And I thought what might be really nice as well also is if we could do a reading for Diane. Diane has sent through a message earlier on today, and now she's a Pisces, and I'm just wondering what you might be able to pick up for her.
So she just wants a general.
Yeah.
That's a good one, celebration.
Oh, isn't it just?
Absolutely wonderful.
Wow.
She's got some really, really good emotional times coming up. I don't think things have been that wonderful emotionally, but it's all about emotions now. And it's like almost as if you've got to sort of embrace the new. Now, I know it says love begins, but it doesn't always have to mean love in the strictest sense of the word. It can mean something that is going to inspire you and make you really happy. Now, I'd almost certainly say, there's the card of celebration, but I would almost certainly say there is a celebration coming up around the two younger males that link to you. And again, I've got the card of going out and having a really good time. The Nine of Cups is a real positive card. So there's two younger male energies to you, polar opposites, but I feel they're linked to you. There's a celebration coming up around those boys, shall we call them. Right, and then the love begins. Now, that can be a situation. It doesn't have to be a person. It could be a new hobby, new idea. I feel it links to work, actually. Some new opportunity to try something that you know, to really go off into a new idea that is really, really going to fulfil you emotionally. Because here we've got the page of pentacles. Now, pages, they're either messages or news. When they're people, they're very young people. On this occasion, I feel this is news about a project or venture or something like that. News about work, news about money. I hate that word, money, but I've got to have to say it, because this is news about work or money, but it's new. So this is something that has not been tried before, because I think things have sort of left you feeling a little bit flat, and it's almost if, like a hobby or an interest or something that you are going to do out of boredom is going to bear fruit, which is really, really interesting. And it would be very interesting to see how that pans out. It's going to involve more travel. It's going to involve you getting out and about a lot more and meeting more people. And ultimately, I feel over the last sort of, I don't know, certainly the last year, you feel that things are working against you. And I want to say that they're not. I want to assure you that everything is moving in the right direction for you. There's a slight tendency to want to interfere or maybe meddle or... the door's just shut on its own, which really, why are we all so shocked? The door's just shut on its own. And you've got two mediums here that have gone, oh, that doesn't really bode well. And also the producer is a medium. And he's gone, oh, like that as well. So, right, back to your reading.
I think it's coming back to our... I'm sorry, Diane, I know it's your reading, but you know the whole humour thing we're talking about? It's shut that
See,
door.
See, we're only human. Shut that door. But I think, you know, please don't think things aren't moving in the right direction or, in fact, moving quickly enough for you. And please don't try and interfere. And I use that with love and respect, that word interfere, when we think things aren't going right for us or aren't moving quickly enough. We have to ask for help. And then what do? We meddle. And then it doesn't go. Things are going in the right direction for you. Really good things to come. But please try and resist meddling. Yeah. You know, let it all happen as it's meant to.
Wow, thank you very, very much, Tracy. Sorry, Diane, for your giggling and our door-shutting spirit.
I didn't giggle.
I giggled.
The door shut me and...
Now, what we've got here in the Mary Magdalene, cards, we've got here the card of crucifixion, which doesn't mean, you know, in literal terms, but it shows these beautiful woodland trees, and I feel a strong affinity there with this kind of woodland environment as a result of this, and it's showing this lovely light coming through here as well, so a sense of peace and harmony from being around nature. I've also got this card here, suffering in silence, which means that sometimes you've been holding back from speaking out what you think and just kind of gazing off into the distance thinking, oh, well, when the time is right. But I would say that really it is time now. Again, you've got revealing radiance as well. I think it's time to be a little bit more selfish in your energy and in looking after your energy and what really works for you. Accompanied by the goddess Freya, that tells you to be bold, unleash your adventurous side, take risks and be daring. Accompanied by a beautiful cat there. And one of these lovely goddess cards here, which shows us dancing underneath the dark moon and radiating our own energies. So really, I feel, and look at this, it's almost with these kind of like shadowy figures all around. You know, we have got Halloween coming up, and I think that this could be a really good, nice time to do a little bit of witchery of your own, Diane, and to actually kind of summon up the next chapter in your life and actually make sure that you're definitely at the forefront enjoying it all rather than putting other people first all of the time. So I hope that's helpful for you. And sorry about the giggles. We had the slamming doors all the way through. Now we have got, what we're going to be doing, we're going to have a lovely lady called Alison come on the telephone just after 8 o'clock, and she's going to be having a live reading with us over the phone, asking questions as well. But before we do go to that break, and it's about 10 to 8 right now, I'm just going to tell you a little bit about how you can get involved with us here at Psychic Oracle Live. This is our psychic interactive show here, and you can see underneath here some information about how you can get involved with the show. Now we do actually have two telephone numbers. One is here and one is showing up on our commercial breaks. It doesn't mean that one's wrong and one's right. They're both there, but they're serving different purposes. 0207 193 6457 is a number that you can call and make an appointment with Tracy. And that would be at a time that suits you. But if you do want to have a reading right now, then what you can do is ring 0207 111 6378 and speak to a receptionist and go through to a psychic right away, or you can also book an appointment, you know, by paying in advance, paying with your credit card or debit card. So there are lots of different ways that you can get involved. You can also come through and book online on the website, which is www.oracletelevision.com, and you can come through and book an appointment there as well. Tracy will be on the website available to book some select VIP appointments with.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. She's not available all the time. Seriously, we're lucky to get her, aren't we?
Well, I didn't want to say that.
But there will be some appointments, you know, basically we can kind of, you know, liaise and sort of get a time that suits you both, and that would be over the telephone. But during the show, what you can do is post your questions or send them to us via private message or email, and then we can give you a free reading during the show. Now, there's lots of different ways that you can do that, and during the break we'll be going through and checking and seeing all the different ways that messages are coming through. First of all, there's our Facebook page where you can also watch this show live. Now that is facebook.com/oracletelevision. It's quite simple. You can post a question on the actual page, or you can send it by a private message, because some people prefer to do that. You can also send it through to my personal Facebook. That's what some people do. It's under Carrie Kirkpatrick, or even on Psychic-Oracle Web TV. That's another profile that we've got on Facebook. You can send us a Twitter message or a tweet, and the handle there is Psychic Oracle. You can also go to our live stream account, and that's Oracle Television, and you can send us a message there, which is where we're live streaming from. Or you can also email us, which is contact@psychicoracle@gmail.com. And we know that everybody has their favourite way, so even if I try to just limit it to one method to sending us through a message, no, people want to choose whatever they want. And they don't always want to have it sitting there on the website or on a Facebook wall for ages for everybody to see. They sometimes prefer to send it through as a private message. That's totally fine with us. So when we have a break, I just go and have a little check through and hopefully not miss any of them.
No.
So what we're going to do in a few minutes' time is we're just going to go to a five-minute break, and we will be back then, and at around about 8 o'clock we will be speaking to Alison. But before we do that, what would you like to hear from people tonight? You know, are there any particular areas that you feel guided that you'd like to talk to them about?
I really don't mind. I think it's got to be what the person has got on their mind.
Yeah.
Not what I want to.
Yeah.
You know, so no, I don't want to talk about that tonight. I want to do work readings. It can't really be like that.
No. So basically, whatever's on your mind.
Yeah.
Whatever's on your mind is whatever's going to be on our mind. So if you want to come through, send a message that's personal to you. Don't worry even if you just say, give me a general reading for what's coming up. I mean, Halloween is just around the corner. It's going to be a very powerful time energetically. Then we've got Christmas coming up. You know, that could be work that's on your mind. It could be family issues. It could be relationships.
Anything.
Perhaps you're wondering who you're going to be snuggling up with as the nights draw in. This is the lady to ask. And you promise you won't be too naughty and saucy with them.
Well, no, I'm going to post a question in the break. You've given me an idea.
Oh.
I'll send a question in.
Oh.
I'm joking.
No,
any questions.
Yeah,
it
any
doesn't
questions
really matter.
Like,
I'm happy. It's whatever is on the person who wants their question asked mind.
And of course,
happy
when you post these questions and send them through to us, it is absolutely free. We do not charge you for these mini readings here. We just want to have a chance to sort of share with you the interactivity of this show, which is relatively new, and to sort of help you get involved and to realise that, you know, we really are here to respond to what you would like to talk about. And so that's why we're quite happy to demonstrate that for free of charge. And if you like what you see and you want to have a more in-depth reading, then you really can do so by going to the website, by phoning us up, by talking to us. We're accessible, we're here for you, and we'd love to hear from you. So we're going to go to that break now, and during this break you're going to see a little bit of information about what's coming up, and also a mind, body, soul event that we're involved with next week, which we'll talk about a little bit later on in the show, after Alison's reading. So do enjoy sort of watching the commercials that we've got coming up and taking note of what's coming up. And we'll be back in about 5 minutes' time. We'll see you after this.
Hello and welcome to the Mind Body Soul Experience 2014. We've got a full programme of workshops throughout the day, two workshop rooms dedicated to all of our teachers, bringing you everything you need to know. And we've got a full programme of performances on our stage with music and chakras and meditation. So it's going to be really exciting. So if you'd like to come along and see us, we'd love to meet you. we're really pleased that there's something for everyone. So for those people who want to listen to someone talking about the things that they're really passionate about or they really really know a lot about, we've got people giving lectures. We've got interactive workshops and demonstrations where people can do guided meditation and that kind of thing. And obviously we've got lots of exhibitors here who want to show you that they've got lots of products available. One of the things I really love about Mind Body Soul is the atmosphere. That first morning when the doors open, or just before the doors open, and everyone's getting ready and you can just feel the excitement. It's a chance to make new friends and it's a chance to meet up with old friends, and it's just a really great atmosphere. Come along, have a look around, visit all of our exhibitors, and then pop down to the Om Yoga Show. Your ticket gets you in for free. If you'd like to come along and be part of this amazing show, just go online and buy a ticket now. Tickets are cheaper online than they are on the door, and if you want to buy a 2 or 3 day ticket, you'll make great savings. So go online and book your ticket now. It's going to be an amazing weekend and we can't wait to see you.
We thrive on social media, as it means that we can talk directly with you, our viewers, all across the world. Please like, follow and share our posts and help us to spread the word about our broadcasts. It's as simple as that.
Good evening and welcome to Oracle TV's Halloween special. My name's Carrie Kirkpatrick and I'm currently standing in Queen's Woods in Highgate, an affluent North London suburb. I'm standing in an area known as the Witch's Coven, surrounded by 13 oak trees with the addition of holly and rowan. This area has been sacred for many, many years as witches have gathered here and conducted many rituals, myself included. Why is it that this woods remains undeveloped, with the price of land being what it is? It's because it is protected, and it is sacred, and it is also the site of a plague pit. What lies at the heart of this wonderful woods, with its mystical, magical energies? If you want to find out more, stay tuned to Oracle TV.
Hello and welcome back to Psychic Oracle Live. My name is Carrie Kirkpatrick and hello.
Hi.
Hello, we've got Ali on the phone. Welcome back to Psychic Oracle Live. My name's Carrie Kirkpatrick. I'm here with Tracy Baker in the studio and we have our first live caller on the show. Obviously, we're using some basic technology here because I just got my radio mic in my hand and the phone on the speaker. So who needs really expensive equipment?
Not us.
So, Ali, I'd like to introduce you to Tracy. I'd like to introduce you to Tracy, Ali.
Oh, hi, Hi,
hello, Ali. How are you?
Nice to speak to you.
You too.
Can you hear us okay?
Yeah, yeah, fine.
So, Ali, I'd like to hand you over to Tracy now. I've told her that you are a Cancerian. That's all I've told her. So would you like to ask her a question or maybe give her full date of birth?
My date of birth is 2/7/65.
And I'll have to have that added up.
Okay.
I can't do that in my head.
All right. So it's the 2/7/65. Our producer's going to help here. 1965, and we're going to give you the number in just a moment.
But first,
2nd of July, 2nd of the 7th, 1965. Number 3.
Oh, that's, you know, that's lucky, really. That's quite lucky with work, sort of emotional happiness, and also with sort of taking on new challenges, and I feel that you put the groundwork down, but I don't feel that you rush in a great lot to anything. I don't know whether that's right or not, but I think there's not much you do without thinking it through first. Would that be right?
Yeah, but I'm not a ponderer. I do think it through, but yeah, once I kind of thought it through, then I'm...
Then you'll do it. Whereas, like myself, I do it, and then after I think, oh, like that. I don't feel that you're like that. Was there anything in particular you'd like me to look at for you?
I'd love sort of the emotional side of things. So, I split up with my husband a year and a half ago, so...
Because I don't like being negative, that as I shuffled the cards, the Three of Swords was there, and I thought, do you know what? I don't want to bring the evening down. I should have left that out, because that's so typical. I'm going to try and find it again now and show you the card, because that in this deck, and I love this deck, I'm always working with it, it's so stereotypical of somebody that hasn't had such a good time. It's a picture of a red heart with three swords piercing it. And that usually, you know, I always think it's not like somebody get a knife in the back. That's like a knife through your heart. And with any marriage or relationship breakdown, whether you're the one that made the end decision or you had the end decision made for you, there's still got to be a period of grieving, mourning and loss. It makes not one iota of difference who's done the divorcing, if you like, or the splitting. There's still a period of mourning to be had now. What I would say with that is the way forward is to not stay too long in that period of mourning and don't stay any longer than you need to. It's okay to grieve, but we have to move on quite quickly. Strangely enough, what I've got here is the Page of Cups. Now, that is a water energy. That is a water vibration. And it's also somebody who's got such a gentle side, very youthful emotionally. I don't mean like immature. I mean young at heart emotionally. Absolutely young at heart with such a lot of love to give. Now, but the thing is where I've get this... The key here is the truth is very important to you. The Hierophant speaks of truth and honesty and also tried and traditional methods. Now, I don't think that you'd be the type of person to enter into a relationship that wasn't going to be quite permanent. I don't see you wanting any dalliances to speak of. You're quite a traditionalist. And the truth is very important to you. And it's also quite important that to be honest with yourself about what it is you want. You are being helped spiritually. You must also use your feminine wiles and your gut feelings and intuition, which is being given to you with regards to relationships. So what is your next question, please?
I run my own business, so... I think while I've been going through the sort of thing of my divorce, I haven't been quite as focused. But I feel even just in the last couple of weeks, I've really turned a corner, which is why that number 3 thing really resonated with me. Yeah.
You absolutely have, because you've got the Ten of Cups here, which is an absolute gem of a card for not only for relationships, but happiness in terms of friendship, home life. You know, you can't ask for a better card than that. It's like the culmination of happiness. And also here, we've got a gentleman on the horizon, and he is, you know, you say you're a business person. I think this man would also be an asset, not only to your personal life, but to your business life as well. This man is no fool. He's quite financially astute, and he's quite financially aware. So you've got that to look forward to. I've got, you know, the Six of Wands, which is the card of success and victory. Now, there may be a few people that might not like your success that is to come, but they're going to have to like it. It's as simple as that. I know you're not the type of person to rub their nose in it, because that's the only downside of this card. You know, it's a victory card, and there's nothing wrong with having a bit of victory and a bit of a pat on the back for yourself, because I feel you've got that to come. But, you know, you can afford to be generous with your energy, if you like. There's no need to begrudge anybody anything, because I think you have some really good things to come. I feel December is going to be quite a good month for you emotionally. You might have to slow down a bit in December, because I think sort of the rest of this month and November are going to sort of whip up a bit of a storm and be like a whirlwind. Yeah. But December, we need to slow it down a bit. And again, the Three of Pentacles is very good for the work. I always see that as two ventures going into one, so watch out for that happening. It's almost as if you amalgamate two things into one that will filter in. And rather two small things, you've got one big thing sort of all-encompassing, which will be quite successful. Very good at what you do. That's what I want to say to that, and it will be successful. It just needs, you know, now you've sort of got your head back on properly. Yeah. I feel, you know, the next sort of 3 months are going to be very good for you.
Fabulous. So I've just bought a house this week, actually, funnily enough, so this is why everything's shifting. So
right.
I want to know if I'm going to be happy in the new place that I've just said that I'm going to buy. So
absolutely. But again, you've got to get things in the right priority, because what I've got here is a lot more, strangely enough, I see more abundance coming your way, more opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
I also see you are a giver, but do be wary of giving away things that you actually do need or will need for yourself. Now, with your home move, Rome wasn't built in a day.
Okay.
So please don't try and get it all in order in the first week that you live there.
Right.
You know, I just see a bit of a getting in a bit of a mess,
right.
Trying to do too much at once, and maybe not necessarily in the right order either.
Okay.
The house. But yes, I think you will be. I feel it's like almost like coming home.
Right.
When you go to your place, your new place, almost like coming home.
Okay, fantastic.
But strangely enough, and I just like to end on a curveball, I think you're going to move again.
Yeah.
But not, I know you've just bought a house. I think you're going to move. I don't think you're staying there for a great period of time. I think you're going to move again within 3 years.
Oh, I'm sure, yeah.
So Alison, are there any questions that you'd like to ask? Any specific questions, like maybe any suitors on the horizon?
Well, there is one guy, actually, that I've met sort of recently.
And do you know what his astrological sign is?
No, I don't, unfortunately.
He's not an earth sign, is he? Like a Taurian or Capricorn?
I really don't know. I'll have to find out.
Don't you know when his birthday is?
No, I don't. Sorry.
Oh, well. Make sure he knows when yours is. So you have a present. You don't need to know when his is. It's not
exactly
important. Tweeting me. Keep them keen.
Irrelevant.
Yeah, there is a man there.
Yeah.
There was the King of Cups. Yeah. One.
So,
Pentacles.
So do you think this might be the one that's
around
at the moment?
I think this could be pretty good, actually.
Yeah.
That looks pretty good. I think you're going on a trip together as well. I think you're going on a break together, out of the country together as well.
Yeah. Little break.
I don't know whether it's going to be for time and all eternity. I want to say let him do the asking. I think he's got issues that he needs to work through. I think there may be, you know, times when he will go quiet.
Uh-huh.
And I want to say just wait for him to become talkative again.
Okay.
If he's quiet, don't go, what's the matter with you? What's the matter with you? You know, a day or so, and he'll be back talkative again. I just feel with him, he's had quite a lot of disruption.
You're spot on, actually, uncannily so.
I think he's had quite a lot of disruption.
Yeah.
Previously. I feel he's still quite hurt.
Right.
I feel quite, you know, a bit battered and bruised around the heart region. He needs to process that out of his system before he can, like when I've said to you earlier, you've got your head on, you've got your head back on now, you're all right.
Yeah.
I don't think he has yet. It's almost as if you're slightly ahead of the game in the healing of the emotions. So he will go quiet, and my gut feeling is to tell you is if he does go quiet for a day or two, let him stay quiet and let him come back, because he will.
Okay, that's really...
But if it's like, what's the matter with you, then he might not.
Yeah.
So you've got to play a little bit of... it's like a game of chess. Let him... And then he'll come back and come back for longer and like that.
Yeah.
But he will sort of go on... I don't like to call them this, but there's only one way I'm thinking, go on a bit of a downer, maybe, because he's still healing.
Yeah.
But I think he'll be fine.
So it's a good one for her to get involved with.
I think
with,
so.
Yeah.
But he's got to... Mm. She's got to let him have his little moody and then come back,
which
he does.
Yeah. And is there anything more to worry about with the ex?
No, because I think this lady would now see the ex off. Got the strength.
Yeah.
I don't think he'd... You know, sometimes when people can... They know who they can get the better of. And then sometimes they look at someone and they go to actually know.
Yeah.
And I think this is what is happening now. I really don't see that, no, because I think there's not very... I don't want to talk disrespectfully about somebody, but I think your ex was a slightly... The only word I could... Because a slightly bad influence for you.
Right.
He wasn't good. So I think what happened had to happen in order for you to progress. You know, people come together for a day, a week, a lifetime, and once we've learned everything that there is to learn from that person, whether it be a person, a job, or it finishes. And I think now you're on to better things. And no, I don't envisage any problems from the ex. I don't know whether you're actually divorced yet, but you will be if you're not.
Because no, I am.
I see the justice card. I don't know what else you've got to sort out then, because I still see some legal paperwork.
Oh, for sure. Well, we're right in the middle of selling our marital home.
Yeah, so there's the finances to be sorted out, because there's more legalities.
Yeah, for sure.
But I feel that they go your way. I think your ex-husband is probably going to take a little bit of a fall. But that really is his life, his journey and his problem.
Mm.
Not yours.
Mm.
But you'll hear about it.
Mm. Wow. Now, I also pulled some cards for you as well, Alison.
Oh, wow.
The first one I've pulled out is... a goddess card, which is called Abundantia, and this is really a goddess of prosperity. It's a money card. It's prosperity. The universe is pouring its abundance out to you. Be open to receiving. Then in my Denise Lynn card, I've got listening with your heart. I trust the messages I receive from my heart. So those are just beautiful ones to start off with. They're already echoing what Tracy was saying. And then I've also got, after that, I've got the lovers. So, you know, definitely, as Tracy was talking about this relationship opening up, I kind of got all these really positive cards coming to do with love. So basically, the prosperity coming in first, that giving you a newfound kind of glow, a radiance around you, listening with your heart. So, and also this is shown with a kind of spiritual mandala symbol on it as well. So there is a sense of spiritual unfolding and harmony with the way that you're listening with your heart. Then you have harmony in a relationship. You're able to be in a position to do that. We've also got the card Mythic Reality, which is really showing a beautiful rainbow, a castle in the distance, and a lovely path leading towards it, which is telling us really, come and you can live your dreams. You can project and fulfill and manifest your dreams, and even glowing with gold with a rainbow on top, why not? And also a beautiful hand-painted card by Tiana, which is showing the beautiful goddess with a new moon symbol around here. I might just put that over there because it's so pretty. And look at her dancing and celebrating the new moon energy. And I really feel, you know, you are a Cancerian. We have kind of like indicated in the past just a little bit about working with the lunar energies, working with the goddess energies. And I think this is something that you will explore a little bit more. So really, it's about opening up, not only to receive and to giving all these lovely qualities, but also to being proactive with it as well, because it's a kind of a two-way process. So is there anything else you'd like to ask us, Alison?
Oh, my God, no. That's a wonderful reader. I couldn't have asked for more. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you so much for sharing your personal life on the internet.
Yes. Yeah.
Nice private reading shared with the whole world.
Thank you so much, and thank you, Tracy.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Thank you very, very much for joining in, and we'll see you again soon.
Yeah, bye. For sure. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
So that was a lot of fun, wasn't it? That worked pretty well, didn't it?
Actually, yeah.
So yes, who needs newfangled technology when you can just take your radio mic off and put it by the telephone?
Yes.
Now, we have had some amazing feedback from Debbie Anderson. Thank you so much, Debbie. She's having a good old chuckle with us. She loved all the laughter.
Oh,
said
good.
How it was really raising the vibration. And she says that we were spot on. You were both of us spot on. In fact, can we just have that information? I think she lives by Lake Erie. She walks down there all the time. So my image of the lake
lovely. Really
came through. She's also making a new deck of cards for children. Vibrational energy cards.
That's good.
And these are for children. So she's very much working with spirit. Everything that you were saying about her work
that
was totally spot on.
That page of the page. Yeah. That's a younger energy as well, isn't it?
She said they were for children.
Yeah.
And thank you so much for your feedback. That was really lovely. What a lovely interaction we've been able to have today.
I know, it's
with lovely Debbie all
it?
The way out in Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Only thing is, we're just totally jealous that you've got Lake Erie down the road, you know. And now you've told us that, we feel a bit like,
there's a few lakes in Milton Keynes, but I don't think they would measure up to Lake Erie.
No.
They're not quite the same.
And I'm in London. We haven't got lakes at all. We've got woods, we've got lots of other
beautiful things. There is a lake. I've seen a lake in London. Serpentine.
Oh, yeah, yes, that's true, yeah. Yes.
I was going to say there is a lake. I've been by it.
It's not the same, though, is it?
It's not the same as Lake Erie, no.
No.
That's probably better.
Yeah, I think so. Well, thank you so, so much. Now, in a moment, we're going to go to a little news bulletin that we've made, sort of advertising what's coming up in October. In the meantime, don't forget that this is the information how you get involved with the show. It's Psychic Oracle Live. We've got a number of different phone numbers, a number of different ways to get involved. Our website is a good place to start, and that's www.oracletelevision.com. You can watch our shows live there. You can watch our pre-records. You can watch edited highlights of our shows. You can also find out how you can come through and book a reading for yourself as well. There are two numbers that we're working with tonight. The one that you appear on the screen is purely for one-to-one appointments with Tracy, and that's 0207 193 6457. But we also do have another telephone number which comes up in our commercial breaks, and that's 0207 111 6378. So don't worry if you didn't get that straight away. They're all on the website, but that's the number that you can phone through and speak to a receptionist right now, have a reading right away with one of our team of psychics that have been picked because the company that supplies them is of a very high calibre. And having been in the industry for a very long time, we were very particular to say that we wouldn't recommend you to anybody on the phones unless we knew that they were of a very high calibre. So it's not a question about going for the biggest that has hundreds and hundreds of psychics all the time. It's about going for the best. And that's what we stand for here at Oracle Television and on Psychic Oracle Live here. So do enjoy this news bulletin. And when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit about the mind, body, soul experience next week that's coming up in a few days' time. So we'll see you on the other side of this. Good evening and welcome to Eye-Opening News from Oracle Television. My name's Carrie Kirkpatrick and I've got some juicy news for you coming up for this month of October. First of all, I'd like to tell you about the Mind, Body, Soul exhibition, a massive mind, body, soul and yoga exhibition in Olympia on the 24th, 25th and 26th of October. Oracle Television are going to be there. We launched there this time last year. And this year we have a lovely stand there, stand number 24, and we are hosting a studio right in the event. Yes, that's right. Oracle TV are going to be filming and broadcasting directly from the Mind, Body, Soul exhibition and yoga show in Olympia. So do come down and see.
Where do you live, Aldo?
Wait a second.
Oh, it's all going out there, isn't it?
Wait a second, I've just made a big mistake.
What did you do, darling?
I don't know, I've just lost the...
Oh, is Tracy going out again?
Yeah, why is Tracy going out? Why isn't this going out? I blinded it up. Oh my goodness. Sorry, Tracy, just be... freeze! I don't know how that happened. I lined it up with a new one. Mm. Oh, do you know what it is? How have you done that? Oh, enter. What I did was I went to click on it and it went straight to it.
Oh, okay.
She can do that, should it?
No.
You know you said line it up for the next one. See? Look, that's what happened.
Oh. Am I
Yeah.
Still going out?
No.
Okay.
You're not. Then I panicked. I thought, oh shit, and I tried to get it back.
Okay.
And that's what I did. I swapped. That's how we got Tracy on.
Yeah. Oh, well, I'll tell you what, just leave it to
leave
run.
It to run
with the Goddess Enchantment, and then that'll be fine. I'm just going to go and check on the live stream page downstairs for a minute. Good evening and welcome to Eye-Opening News from Oracle Television. My name's Carrie Kirkpatrick and I've got some juicy news for you coming up for this month of October. First of all, I'd like to tell you about the Mind, Body, Soul exhibition, a massive mind, body, soul and yoga exhibition in Olympia on the 24th, 25th and 26th of October. Oracle Television are going to be there. We launched there this time last year. And this year we have a lovely stand there, stand number 24, and we are hosting a studio right in the event. Yes, that's right. Oracle TV are going to be filming and broadcasting directly from the Mind, Body, Soul exhibition and yoga show in Olympia. So do come down and see us at stand 24. Perhaps you'd like to come and be interviewed. Perhaps you'd like to come and see some of our celebrities who are being interviewed on our stand, stand 24. That's the place to be. Also, coming a little bit further on in the month, on the 30th of October, coming up the night before Halloween, the Pagan Federation are hosting an open ritual, a Samhain ritual. It's always the event of the year. It's in Conway Hall in Red Lion Square, the place that we also held our evening of mediumship earlier on in the year. It's being hosted by Sarita de Esther and the Covenant of Hecate. It promises to be a good one. Get there early because it will be packed. It only costs about £5 to get in. Get there for 7 o'clock. It's going to be an incredible group ritual, an amazing social evening. So we hope to see you there. Now, another thing that's been coming up a lot recently in the news is a lot of anger amongst pagans and witches about the use of the name ISIS in the news when referring to the Islamic State terrorists. Now, we try not to get too involved with politics here at Oracle TV, but people who are involved in paganism, especially the Fellowship of Isis, of course, I'm a priestess of the Fellowship of Isis, and other businesses with the name Isis have been enraged that her name has been used in this context. Isis is, of course, an Egyptian goddess that is revered by many, many people and has got nothing to do with terrorism or atrocities. And for too long, the media kept referring to the terrorist group as ISIS instead of ISIL, or now they're calling it IS, which we're very pleased about. So thank goodness all that pressure that's been put on the media has actually worked. And I think the Huffington Post led the way. So thank you very much to the Huffington Post. Now, don't forget that Grant Collier and Sam EB Psychic are going to be hosting Becoming Psychic radio show this Thursday evening, as they do every Thursday night. It's going to be featuring amazing guests, free readings by Grant Collier. And we had him on the Spirit Show just a couple of weeks ago, and everyone who is watching knows just how good he is. So do stay tuned, follow them on Facebook and listen in on their radio show on Thursday night. The Sonier Society have got an incredible event coming up in Newbattle Abbey in Scotland. Now, this promises to be a great event with esoteric researchers, historians giving fantastic lectures. Oracle TV are going to be there, and we're going to be filming this event this time in this incredible Newbattle Abbey, this location. I've wanted to go there for years, so we're really looking forward to that. If you'd like to come and join us, just look up the Sonier Society online and book yourself in. Now, we've also got two special shows coming up for you on Oracle TV. Do join us over the Halloween period. We've got a Halloween special on Sunday, the 2nd of November. We're going to be looking at the history of the Witch's Coven, the sacred space in Queenswoods, where we've filmed a lot of rituals, we've taken part in a lot of rituals, and looking into the history behind this incredible location. We've also got a new series being launched just after Halloween, and that's Beyond the Veil, Past Lives Revealed, featuring Francesca McDonald, incredible international psychic medium, in a series of programs looking at past lives, why you should look at them, what they mean to you, and how you can work with them to great effect. Stay tuned and we'll see you soon. I'm Carrie Kirkpatrick, and I'd like to welcome you to the world of goddess enchantment, magic and spells. These books aren't just for the experts amongst you, these are also for beginners, those who just wish to explore the psychic world, the spiritual world, the pagan world. There's a little bit of something for everybody in Goddess Enchantment, Magic and Spells, Volumes 1 and 2. In Volume 1, we deal with the pagan Wheel of the Year. Now, even though this has Celtic origins, we have also included goddesses from different pantheons, and we've created beautiful pictures along with visualizations and spells, and some history about each goddess. In Volume 2, we deal specifically with goddesses of love, abundance, and transformation. Not everyone can have a statue of their favourite goddess for their altar, so the idea of these photographs is that you can use them as a focal point on your altar. You can place the candles in front of them, make offerings, place the flowers, and sit and meditate on these images and get a connection to the goddesses by practicing the visualizations and the rituals detailed in the books. You can also download the pictures of the goddesses onto your iPad or Kindle and use that as a digital altar as well. So this is a very modern way of working with the goddesses, and you can have an altar wherever you may be in the world. As a psychic, I have worked with people for many, many years who like to develop their own spiritual and psychic abilities. And what does that actually mean? Many people do actually like to learn how to meditate, to connect with their higher self, to connect with a certain something other. And why is that? Because they want to learn more about themselves, maybe to understand what they're going through in their lives, to improve themselves.
And that also leads us into the area known as cosmic ordering, focusing their will, their wishes, on manifesting that which they want in their lives. The results speak for themselves, and there's a general feel-good factor after doing these kind of meditations. Try it for yourself.
Hello and welcome to the Mind Body Soul Experience 2014. We've got a full programme of workshops throughout the day, two workshop rooms dedicated to all of our teachers, bringing you everything you need to know. And we've got a full programme of performances on our stage with music and chakras and meditation. So it's going to be really exciting. So if you'd like to come along and see us, we'd love to meet you. We're really pleased that there's something for everyone. So for those people who want to listen to someone talking about the things that they're really passionate about or they really really know a lot about, we've got people giving lectures. We've got interactive workshops and demonstrations where people can do guided meditation and that kind of thing. And obviously we've got lots of exhibitors here who want to show you that they've got lots of products available. One of the things I really love about Mind, Body, Soul is the atmosphere. That first morning when the doors open, or just before the doors open, and everyone's getting ready and you can just feel the excitement. It's a chance to make new friends and it's a chance to meet up with old friends, and it's just a really great atmosphere. Come along, have a look around, visit all of our exhibitors, and then pop down to the Om Yoga Show. Your ticket gets you in for free. If you'd like to come along and be part of this amazing show, just go online and buy a ticket now. Tickets are cheaper online than they are on the door. And if you want to buy a 2 or 3 day ticket, you'll make great savings. So go online and book your ticket now. It's going to be an amazing weekend and we can't wait to see you.
We thrive on social media as it means that we can talk directly with you, our viewers, all across the world. Please like, follow and share our posts and help us to spread the word about our broadcasts. It's as simple as that.
Good evening and welcome to Oracle TV's Halloween special. My name's Carrie Kirkpatrick and I'm currently standing in Queen's Woods in Highgate, an affluent North London suburb. I'm standing in an area known as the Witch's Coven, surrounded by 13 oak trees with the addition of holly and rowan. This area has been sacred for many, many years as witches have gathered here and conducted many rituals, myself included. Why is it that this woods remains undeveloped, with the price of land being what it is? It's because it is protected, and it is sacred, and it is also the site of a plague pit. What lies at the heart of this wonderful woods, with its mystical, magical energies? If you want to find out more, stay tuned to Oracle TV. Thank you.
my name is Francesca McDonald. I'm an international psychic medium and spiritual healer. I'm delighted to tell you about an upcoming series of shows that I'm going to be doing on Oracle Television. I'm going to be doing some past life specials. Past life karma can affect us all. Does it affect you? Past life karma can bring forward phobias and fears from the past, but it can also give us that connection with people we know we haven't met in this lifetime, but we still feel incredibly drawn to. Would you like to find out more? Keep watching Oracle TV.
Hello and welcome to Psychic Oracle Live. My name is Carrie Kirkpatrick and tonight I am joined by psychic medium Tracy Baker.
Hello.
Hello, Tracy. Thank you for coming in this evening. Now, before the break, we had a live reading with Alison, and we've had some amazing feedback from Ali, and that's come through on my mobile. Wow, that was fab, in capital letters, with lots of exclamation marks.
Oh, good.
Thanks, with lots of kisses. So she really, really loved that, really appreciated that. But, you know, to be fair, that was an amazing live reading that you did, Tracy.
Oh, thank you. Well, it's not me, though, is it, really?
It's the guides, isn't
yes.
it? Yeah.
I say that, really. People... It is nice when people go, I want to, but it isn't me.
Yeah. See, there's no better demonstration of what a psychic can do is to actually show a live reading here. Now, sometimes we have guests come into the studio and sometimes it's not always possible. So doing it like this, where you've got the interaction, that's where you really, you know, it's the acid test, you know, where the person having the reading is saying things like, yes, that's spot on. Yes, you were right. Yes, yes, yes. And that's what we were getting there with Ali. And,
yeah.
And well done to you, Tracy.
Thank you.
And it was interesting when I took the Oracle cards out, all they seemed to do was just
echo
the highlights. Yeah. And it's also very interesting, I think, for two psychics to work together and to
yes.
actually do joint readings, because we will find this kind of overlap and this kind of echoing of the same themes and the same messages coming through. So thank you once again, Ali, for getting involved with the show. We've also had some more feedback from Debbie Anderson in Canada.
Oh, right.
And she said, keep up the good work, Tracy. Your energy is so vibrational.
Aww.
Really, really good.
She's
a massive compliment there.
Aww.
Because, you know, your energy was really resonating with her all the way over there in Canada.
I know, it's good, isn't it?
I know, it's very exciting.
I bet she can hear me as well without
yeah,
the mic.
And we've all been having a good old giggle together.
Oh, we have,
you know, so it's a huge network of... A gaggle of giggling ladies.
A gaggle of giggling.
And with Ali as well.
A giggling
and Diane,
gaggle.
A gaggle of giggling ladies.
Try saying that.
Try saying that after a few drinks.
Yes.
It's not going to happen, is it?
No. Well, it would happen.
Yeah.
But best not live on the show.
Yes, absolutely. A bit of a tongue twister.
Yes.
Now, we've had another message come through on Facebook. You know, there's more than one way of getting involved with us on Facebook. We do have our Facebook page, which is facebook.com/Oracle Television. But we also have Psychic Oracle Web TV as a profile. And we've had a message come through from Kate Aylmore. And she said, am I going to pass my driving test?
I've just got the distinct feeling this might be one of my viewers. Slid
a
under
fan,
the rug.
Yeah. A fan. Well, this is what we used to find on the psychic channels, is that when we'd kind of like go off the radar and then suddenly crop up again on another channel, we would get the same regulars coming forward, you know, kind of coming and said, there you are, I've got
yeah.
my reading, please. So I think what's happened with... is it Kate or Kay?
Kay
at Aylmore. I think what's happened with Kay is that she's found you and she's gone, Tracy's on telly.
Well, she knows
again.
Us coming on.
Yeah.
Because I shared it on my Facebook
yeah,
page,
yeah.
both my personal page and my professional page. And I did share it.
Yeah.
When you put it, why
yeah.
not?
And it didn't have the link. I had to go around and check everyone had the right link.
Yeah.
It wasn't going through the Oracle software company.
So...
Because get their lawyers onto me.
We don't want them here anyway.
No!
They're not having any food and drink.
I know they're
all
really
coming
big,
on the show.
But I'm sorry, I think that we deserve to have the name Oracle because, you know, this is oracular work.
Well, you deserve to have the name Oracle because it's the name of your company.
Yeah. Yeah, well, they sort of had it first and were bigger. But
we're not interested
in
them, though.
No, we don't care about that.
We're just letting...
We wish them all the best. Absolutely. If any of their lawyers are watching, obviously. Right. Quick disclaimer in there. But, you know, we're named after the Oracle of Delphi, for goodness sake. You can't argue with that. There wasn't any software or programming going on there, was there?
No, not at all.
Yeah.
So we need to know a driving test. You picked the card.
Okay.
Just lack of responsibility on my part. Right. I think you've got some obstacles to overcome here, because it's almost some, like, there's somebody that would find it hilarious if you didn't. And I think that we need to focus, because you do need to do this. I want to say you will pass it, but I'm not altogether sure if it's on the first time you go for it, because there is success there, but I've just got this feeling of the need to pass the test. What do I want to say? The need to pass the test is crucial in your mind. And sometimes when we want something so badly, we can put so much sort of energy and focus into it, and so determined not to make a mistake that we might make one. So I'm going to sort of be a little bit of a chicken here and err on the side of caution. And I think you might do it the second time. But what I don't want is for you to lose hope if you don't do it the first time. Because there's so much riding on this, as I feel it. And so much, you're so, you know, oh, I better not do this, I better not do this, I better not do this. Oh, my God, I've done it. Oh, my God, what am I going to do now? Like that. Because I think it's very important. I think you will want it so bad that there's a potential to make a little bit of a, I can't say what I want to say. It's three words. The second two are it up, and you might, just because you want it so bad. But you will get it the second time, no doubt in my mind, if not the first.
Was it male hen?
Yeah. Okay. Along those lines.
You don't want to male hen it up.
No, because sometimes you want something so bad and you go, oh, and then it goes wrong.
I'm taking out three cards here as well, and I feel that the second time too, I had the card of the waiting game with a strong number two indicated there as well. But the difficulty is that you could find yourself going in highs and lows and highs and lows, and you could be sitting there going, it's all well and good, it's all well and good, but you know, it's the money, it's the money, it's the money. It's like you really do have to realise that you're coming into your own in all of this. And even when you said obstacles on that first test, I feel as though it's almost like a bit of bad luck, like it might be bad conditions on the road, or somebody's doing something really blooming awkward on the road, and you're like, if only that hadn't happened, and everyone's going, oh, bad luck, because, well, you know, so there could be something like that. But you know, that's what driving is all about. And if it makes you feel any better, I passed on my fifth occasion, all right, fifth, and I've been driving for years now. So sometimes it is just about getting your harmony, your energy in balance with the energy of the road and of everyone around there, for all their hazards and all their nightmares. And, you know, if you ever have an accident in your life, it's because someone else caused it, not you, because there are people out there that are really kind of reckless. So it doesn't matter that maybe you have to retake one time because something happened because of someone else. It's not your fault. But this is about kind of being more comfortable in your energy and more comfortable in your space, and being able to take that with you when you're in amongst traffic. It's not just about showcasing your skills of what you can do in a little metal box that happens to be moving. It's about how you are with all of the kind of craziness that can sometimes happen out there, with other people behaving badly and pedestrians just charging out and all this kind of stuff. So, and I always get this image of a multi-story car park as well. So I don't know if there's a kind of thing like, do they ever, I know sometimes they start your tests in funny places. I don't know if they make you go into a multi-story car park, or you're going past a multi-story car park. It's being shown to me almost like the one that I see near Wood Green, and the rare occasions I go there, which is quite a big sprawling one that you have to go around the back and drive in, and part of it's open, and you have so many levels and layers. So you could find that there's some kind of reference to this multi-storey car park. I somehow think it's unlikely that they would make you go into it as part of your test. So maybe it's just nearby where you are at that time. So do have heart, take heart, and go with the flow with all of this, and realise that if you don't, maybe be wrong, and you're going to come back and go, hey, guess what, I got it first time.
I hope so.
But there will be a little bit of an obstacle along the way, but the potential is there that you might need to do it twice. So we're not saying it's set in stone, we're just saying there's a few kind of obstacles and challenges on the day, and if you do find you're having to do it a second time, it's absolutely fine, and you'll get it that time at least by then, because you will have it. You will have it.
I mean, I see the driving, you know, I can see that, but it's just, will I pass my test? The answer to that is yes.
Yeah.
But I'm not altogether sure if it's on the first.
Yeah.
There's something, and I've got to concur with you on that, there's something with that first drive out with the examiner.
Yeah.
And that's making me nervous. It's wobbling me, that is.
It's almost like you could be talking about it afterwards with experienced drivers, and everyone's going, oh, no. You know, it's an anecdote. It's a story that you can tell of something that happened. You know, so I feel, you know, it's not just a straightforward drive.
I just think, I've had my driving licence since, you don't want to know. And one of my friends took her test.
Yeah.
And she was really good, a very, very proficient learner. And she got round the test. Now, this is bad luck, and this is what I think you might be referring to. All she forgot to do was look over her shoulder as she pulled away from... You know you have to do a reel...
Yeah. Yes.
..like that. So you can't just...
I can even do that now.
But she... Well, me neither. All she did was forgot to look back as she pulled away from the test centre. She did her three-point turn, she did her hill start, she did everything. And all she forgot to do was that, and he failed her. The examiner failed her. She didn't pass.
Basket.
And
that was
yeah, exactly. I mean, yes, nicely recovered. But it depends, again, another examiner might have said, you do realise you didn't look when you pulled.
Yeah.
I will pass you, but...
Yes.
Yeah, you know, I stalled the car on my test and I still passed. Mm. Now, another examiner
might have
failed me. And it's something like that.
Yes, it's very,
borderline.
So just be calm and comfortable within yourself and realise that the pressure, this is not the biggest deadline in your life. You know, I think that's part of it as well.
I know how important it is to this lady, though.
But you're going to have it.
You are.
Whether it's the first time or the second time, you're going to have it. So you just got to go with the flow and what your guides do on the day. Okay? And that's in itself, if you can get that sense of calm and that groundedness.
Yes.
And also, there's this whole thing about not being too attached to the outcome. And we talk about this in spiritual circles. And it's easier said than done sometimes, because we think, this is my goal, I've got to achieve this, I'm sorry, I've got to come on, make it happen.
And you will achieve it.
Yeah. Now, but the thing is, when we talk about not being attached to the outcome, we're not saying about just be completely detached from it, because obviously this is really important and it is going to happen. It's coming your way. You're going towards it. But if you're not too attached to the outcome of passing the driving test on the day of it, I'm not saying don't visualise success. Visualise yourself driving happily. You're going to have that. But don't be so focused and anxious about that outcome that you're actually disrupting your own flow and your own energy, which is essential for the process of manifesting
and
becoming it. So it sounds as though I'm talking in riddles, but it's about harmonics of you in relation to the rest of the world around you, the energies that you're projecting, the energies that you're going along with, the energies that you're receiving, and that's about being in flow. So interesting to apply that to something as nerve-wracking as a driving test, because I found my driving test absolutely awful.
Oh, no.
I used to freak out because I'd have this weird person sitting there and being psychic, and they wouldn't communicate, and they're like... And I was like...
Well, they don't do that.
They freak me out. And you know what I did, just to sort of sucker for punishment? I'd had an automatic test for many, many years, an automatic licence, because I only ever drove automatic.
Right.
And then I decided that I was going to retake my test and do a manual.
God.
God knows why I decided to do this. And I told everybody at work, I was working at the BBC, and they were going, I don't know why you bothered to tell us, you know, because, of course, then suddenly everybody knew.
Yeah.
And I had to do the theory thing, and I had to do all this kind of stuff, because obviously the first time I took it, we didn't have to do things like a theory test. I didn't sleep for 3 nights.
No, it's horrible.
I was terrified. I was having sleepless nights. I was going, what is wrong with you? You've already got a driving licence. They're not going to take it away from you. But it was horrendously nerve-wracking, because I'd had to take it 5 times back in the day, and I still had this subconscious fear of just how unpleasant I found the actual test experience compared to how I was driving. They were two different things as far as I was concerned. So I had quite a trauma with it. Why I did it a second time? I passed, by the way. Just to let everyone know I passed. But it's like, oh, my God.
I know. I wouldn't
it's
want to do mine
again.
It's a
weird old experience. It really will. Yeah. It really is. So if you can just spiritually just really be in your energy and be fine, you know, you're fine. Don't try to have a rapport with this person sitting next to you in the car, because they are just a bit alien. I found them a bit alien. You know, just be fine, be calm, be grounded, just be sensible, and then you go with the flow, okay?
Mm.
God, driving tests.
That's you've a question
up a nightmare
and a half, though,
now. You've stirred up a nightmare now.
Absolutely.
Now, we've also had a message here. This is from Shaw Margaret Cohen. And this is a message that I failed to answer in the last show, so I promised her that we would answer
did
in this
you?
Show. I'm so sorry. It's
not
because,
good enough.
So sorry. It's just because we had so many different avenues of people sending in messages that we didn't realise that this message was sitting there in the live stream account. So I promised that we would answer it on this show.
Okay.
And it was a mediumistic question, really, because we had Kim Alexis on 2 weeks ago. All it was is, are there any messages for me? So there's no other information there. So if you want to take a moment.
Okay. I need more than a moment, actually. I'm just trying to.
Well, I'm going to start off by giving her.
Yeah, if you could just. What's the lady's name?
Shaun Margaret Cohen. Or even Shaun Margaret Cohen. But S-H-A-W-N, I think it's got an N.
I get the feeling that the light switches go in her house on their own.
Oh.
You know the door shut here on its own?
Yeah.
I think the lights go on, the light switches go. I'm really drawn to that. I kept looking at, well, why am I looking over at the light switches? I've also got somebody that got like a, I think, I don't know what they called it years ago. They call it like a COPD now, with the passed over with like real sort of like an emphysema or something like that. I feel the person was a heavy smoker. I feel it's male.
Yeah.
An incredibly heavy smoker. They showed me like fingers of that colour. You know, people used to smoke unfiltered cigarettes.
Yeah.
And real, real bad emphysema. I mean, nowadays they'd have one of those machines and that, but I don't feel there was anything like that then. It comes through very strongly and around you, and you should really know who this man is. I feel it's on your mum's side of the family.
Mm.
But I still want to go on about the light switches keep going on and off in the house.
I've pulled out, interestingly enough, I've got a 6 cards here. I want to say that it feels to me as though you know, in quite a comfortable situation in your life, you know, in your circumstances of where you live. But I have the death card and the disruption card coming up upside down. That's not a negative thing, but it just feels to me as though somebody, they'd passed almost quite suddenly. And, you know, even if they'd been ill, it feels to me like it was quite sudden when they actually passed. And so they didn't get a chance to sort of, you know, straighten things out before they went, or just kind of set things straight. And I don't think that they were necessarily a spiritual, you know, they were sort of spiritually, they had spiritual potential within themselves. But at the same time, it was sort of a question of just not necessarily really exploring it. So they feel as though, they feel to me as though they want to have a little bit of a chance to kind of go, oh, I'm all right, I'm all right. You know, it's all been a bit startled. But because you do have an awful lot of lovely sun energy around you, and you do have an awful lot of light that you can give out, you need to sort of, sometimes you hold it back, and I don't know why you're holding it back. You don't need to hold it back. But I do feel that there's this sense of just keep giving out this beautiful sunny energy that comes from your solar plexus, and that this is like something that kind of like really kind of lifts the vibration of everybody around you. And that I would say that it's really about you acknowledging your own strengths, your own skills. You know, we've got the card here of the prophet showing a beautiful light in the tree and the light around the roots. And it's just saying, acknowledge the feminine, the power of the feminine within your family, within your life, you know, within your energy, within your home. Sometimes you're pulling it back a little bit as though you don't feel confident enough with it all. And it seems to me that the message here is saying, come on, shine a little bit more.
Lovely.
Yeah, very, very nice. I love doing joint readings with you, Tracy. It's been a few years, hasn't it?
Five. Slightly more than five, I think.
Six.
No, not five. Six. It was the early part of 2009, I believe. Or
no, actually, well, wasn't it going into 10? Because my books came out in 2011. Oh, no, after,
yeah, you did,
because we had the second incarnation of that channel in London.
But you were there the first
bit. In the asylum.
But before that, in Bletchley,
yeah,
that was like the spring, summer of 2009.
Yes, that's right, yeah.
And then you went and did other things, and then we met again in the asylum.
In the asylum.
So the lunatics had then taken over the asylum. And we met again.
Now the lunatics got their own studio.
No, the lunatics don't need an asylum because we've got their own studio. And yes, the walls are white.
Yeah.
So all good here. 2010 must have been the last. 11, January 11.
Yes.
So it's still nearly 4 years.
Yes, absolutely. Because it was just before my books came out.
Yes.
And I was just finishing them off. Yeah. Oof. Goodness me, that was a time. Now, Jerry, we have a little message here from Jerry that we're going to say, can I have a general reading, please? And we're going to give Jerry a reading, aren't we? Now, didn't you say, Jerry is a Gemini, isn't he?
Yes, he is. He is a Gemini. And I know that to be a fact.
Oh.
Because I know his birthday is. I'm going to make this good because I'd actually like him to speak to me again. You know, so I don't really want to. Because it would make for a good show on the 16th for you if we are not speaking, wouldn't it? That would be a really good show. Two psychics that aren't speaking to each other.
Yeah.
Mind you, it wouldn't be the first time we've worked with people like that.
I've actually done a psychic show with somebody that
who wasn't speaking to you.
Absolutely. And funnily enough, the producer had asked us to do a theme of anger at that particular point. And I was like, oh my goodness me, you just have no idea. Because we'd had the huge falling out and we were keeping it quiet so nobody else was affected by it at work.
And you had to work together.
And suddenly, you know, the producer said, I think we'll talk about anger today, about what makes you really angry. And so the other
That's what makes me really angry. That would kick it off nicely.
It was funny. I did, my whole theme was all about diffusing the anger and not having a big confrontation when they were like, confront them, have it. And I was like, oh, we're going to be really
so
can't
you're
go.
Even we're up really in the row trying, oh my God.
We really
God.
Can't go there because it was live and, you know.
Yeah, well,
it
no.
Just, no. I thought if we go there, we're going to come to blows.
Big fight on the, with all the cards going
in.
The over.
Ratings would have gone through the roof. I think
it'd absolutely.
Be quite fun, yeah.
It would have done good. You might have got a pay rise or something.
Not in that company, I don't think.
No. No. Right, let's see. Just a general reading for Jerry. Yeah. 15th of June, don't give the year away,
no.
Or he won't speak to me again. Right, okay. Looking around for things to do at the moment, I feel. Oh, well, you won't have to wait too much longer, will you? Bill, at the moment, things are sort of maybe running a little bit flat, a little bit fed up, a little bit, you know, feel like you're dragging your feet a bit, maybe a little bit quieter than one likes to be. But you know what? You might as well just make the most of this time because I don't think it's going to last because I think things start to pick up again within the next month or so. Now, an opportunity comes your way, and I don't want to be like, it's difficult, I know him, you mustn't let your own self belief stop you. It's like, oh my God, I won't be able to do that. I think you will. There's some choices to be made here. I feel somebody from the past might get back in touch. I want to say, you know, I'm not really one to give an opinion, but if it were me, I wouldn't answer them. But that's the feeling I get around it. I just feel either don't answer or give like a real, you know, like nonplussed. Oh, I like that word. Nonplussed. Like a, yeah, whatever type answer. You know, like as if, just like a banal answer. But me being me, you're like a gentle Gemini, maybe at one day down the next. I'm an Aries, that'd be like, no, like, pff, or I just wouldn't answer. I would say, don't answer. It's about picking, choosing friends and people wisely. But this sort of period where you're dragging your feet and thinking, oh, this isn't going to last, I would say make the most of it. Opportunity comes, take it. Don't think, oh, no, I really can't do that. You can. Someone from the past getting back in touch, don't answer. But I think that's really good. But it's about not being swayed by sort of temptation or being reeled in. Don't let anyone reel you in. You know, that's what I think.
OK. I'm going to pull some cards out now for you, Jerry, as well. The first goddess card I've pulled out for you is Vesta, which is the goddess of the home and of the hearth. And it says your household situation is improving, either through a move or a healthy change in its occupants, or even like, you know, when we say a move, it can often be a move within the property, something changing within the property. So call upon the goddess of the hearth, Vesta. I mean, that, I know you may think Vesta sounds like that kind of that company that makes food or makes sauces and things like that. Well, they, like many other companies, have taken their brand name from the name of an original ancient goddess. So Vesta, the goddess of the hearth, there would always in ancient Rome be a statue of Vesta in every household as a blessing for the home and the hearth, obviously focused around the fire. So, you know, fire, food, nourishment being a very important part of that. So, again, a very good time to sort of, like, nourish yourself in joy and maybe even create those extra sort of meals that you were thinking, you know, might be a bit of a treat or you don't have the time for it. I also take out here with the Magdalene Oracle a very beautiful card called Saint Sinner. And this is interesting because it's almost about how to judge oneself or not judge oneself. What's right, what's wrong? Are you too harsh on yourself? Are you considering, you know, this very black and white view of being like sort of a saint or a sinner, or it's good or it's bad? When in fact, really, it's about just completely walking in your own truth and your own power and having complete faith in your own integrity. And that your own way is the right way. Don't be down on yourself because you feel a certain way about something and that another part of your brain is going, oh, that's bad. You know, I feel it's about owning your own truth in that respect. If I come through to the Denise Lynn cards, I've got Savouring Pleasure, and this is a beautiful card for pampering, and it shows a big bathtub overflowing, and there's lovely bubble baths and candles and roses and mirrors and all sorts of things that you normally would associate with women pampering themselves in the bathroom. So I would say that really this is about purification and enjoyment and pampering yourself all at the same time in whichever way suits you. It doesn't have to be bubble baths and roses and scented oils, but it might be aromatherapy, and it might even be working with the energy of having a bath as a kind of a spiritual cleansing process as well, whether it's we're using Epsom salts or sometimes using salt as a sense of cleansing and purification, you know, maybe a bit of rosemary oil, for example, and using that kind of bathing experience as a form of clearing your aura and as a form of an opportunity to do some meditative magic as well. I feel that maybe a little bit of clearing and cleansing the energy on a regular basis would be quite good for you as well. And I'm being drawn to your feet also as well. It's essentially, I don't know whether you might want a bit of reflexology or you might even be finding a certain oil or something to actually rub into the feet and how it's really resonating and doing some kind of holistic healing therapy there for you as well. Animals are very strong around you. And I do know that to be true, but I know that animals are very strong around you. And I feel that walking out with them is very enlightening. I want to say that you get a lot of knowledge coming through from your ancestors when you're out walking with animals. And this is a beautiful goddess card that I've brought here for you. It shows a goddess figure with lots of long white hair. Again, bringing through lunar energy, but look how that energy is coming from the arms and sort of like spinning all around. And I feel that really, I want to tune, because it's long white hair like that, I want to tune in with the ancestors, the elders, those that have gone before, and really bring through their dynamic energy. So it's a kind of a shamanic element that I get through coming here. And those I describe it in quite a vague and abstract way, but it feels like it's a certain energy, a certain current that comes through you when you're out walking with the animals.
Aww.
And we'd like some pictures of those animals, please, to come through on the show. Yeah.
Yes.
I'm knocking my microphone here.
We
sorry
would like
about
some
that.
Yeah. Pictures of them.
Yes. Now, we do have another question here. We're going to do a reading for Rich and Jess, who are hoping to move and sell a property. And it's, you know what it's like, it's never smooth, is it?
Oh, it's awful.
It can be very stressful. So
I think it's one of the most awful
things. And they do have a family, but I think they'd like a little bit of guidance as to how that move is going to go. I think they're getting ready to move out in place, but they need to sell a property and find something to buy.
Right.
And there's children involved.
So let me
involved,
to get this so right. School. So have they moved out of what the one they owned to or rented to sell
the... I think they're going to have to, yeah. I think that's, the, as far as I understand it, they need the sale to go through
right.
smoothly, but they need to find something that they want as well.
Right, so...
Because they
so
lost
what,
out
what,
on something.
So what they've got is their own house. They're going into rented while that sells.
Yes.
And then they'll...
Yeah.
That's a good idea, actually, because they'll be in a position.
Yeah, yeah. But they've got children,
right.
And obviously, you know, it has to areas and schools and things
right.
like that.
And let's look at the one that they're selling at the moment, then. Because that's like a... Look at the one they're selling, look at the one they're renting, then look at the one they're going to buy. Right, they will sell. There's no doubt in my mind,
fantastic.
Because money comes
yes.
from the sale. Let's have a look at that from when.
Yeah.
Right, and there's the sign in. It wouldn't surprise me if it doesn't sell very quickly.
Yeah, okay.
I'm feeling quite imminent. I don't know if it's already sold.
I'm not entirely sure, but I know
because
the question was, can we have some advice on it all? Yeah.
I just feel that would be quite...
Yeah.
That's now.
That's now,
so
yeah.
And I wouldn't have thought it was next year.
No.
I think that's now, because the money's there.
I think they're getting ready to move out. I think they're moving out into
so
the
so it's sold.
Yeah.
I just feel
yeah.
if it hasn't sold, it will.
Mm.
So let's just rent it. Place.
Yeah.
Let's have a look at that. Actually, that'd be quite good. I don't know if it's slightly... I don't think you'd like it at first, where you find, but I think it's about what's suitable at the moment, and I don't think it feels like it's going to be like a long term, but I think you will grow to like it. Where do I want to put you? Ah. It's almost as if when you go and rent somewhere... It's almost as if it's like you've got no choice but to have it. Mm. And then that doesn't feel very nice. Well, it's like, well, it's going to be that or the car. And we can't do that with children, you know. Different when there's only one of you, man, bloke, you know, just keeping the car. And it's like, well, if we don't take this, it's got to be the car. That's their, that's deliberate, actually. That's the deliberate... Is it like a free will, or there's no such thing as free will? That's like that's all that's available, so you have to take it. And I think that's a little bit of spirit at work pushing you into that place. Now, I feel you will buy somewhere, and I'm going to go around to before next autumn. You've actually moved into your own home again, and it's got a really something about this, a beautiful garden that brings you peace in the home that you buy. So worry too much about the rented. I feel you take it for like 6 months and then another 6 months. I feel like we'll take it for the year. But by next autumn, you've got a really... There's such peace. And for some reason, I don't see... Because of you buying and selling, I don't see being too short of money either. It's really odd how it seems to flow beautifully. But the fly in the ointment is the rented house that you don't want. But it seems that there isn't anything else. And I think that's deliberate, because you're meant to go in that one and then you get somewhere else to live of your own.
Ooh, Thank you very, very much. Now I'm going to have a little look here as well for you, Rich and Jess. I'm going to take one of these. Ultimately, yes, I've got this Ace of Swords, upside down, triumphant success. You feel a little bit defeated by the fact that you're having to go down this route because you're always driving together and pushing things forward and usually without any obstacles really to speak of. So you see this as a bit of a setback, but at the end of the day, it really isn't. It's okay. And I've got the card here of spiritual union. So it's just telling me here that the love between the two of you is so strong that really... this can overcome everything, and it's not really about accepting any sense of defeat. It's going to be fun, it's going to be exciting, the children aren't going to mind at all. We've also got here the card of acceptance and going with the flow. So obviously, you know, accept that this is the right step for you to take right now. The goddess that we get is Rhiannon, sorceress. So it is a good time. You are a magical person who can manifest your clear intentions into reality. That's fine. Just because it hasn't happened exactly how you wanted on the first try, at the first month, doesn't mean that it's not working. And so work with the goddess Rhiannon and understand that, you know, there's a greater sense of, I want to say that the dynamic between the two of you changes for the better. It's beautiful, and it was a strong relationship to start off with, but it becomes even more beautiful, and there's a sense of fluidity that comes with it because of this stage that you're taking. If I go with a Denise Lynn card, I'm bringing you through cultivating prosperity. So this is about refocusing, doing your manifesting work together. And also looking in, I'd say that in the new place, Tracy's already picked up on the need for the garden, but I would say that this is an opportunity also to plant food there as well, to grow your own food. And again, look at this beautiful Samhain-related card. It's not the only Samhain-related card in this goddess deck, but the fact that there's this dark moon and the fact that there are the figures in a circle around this figure, and they're slightly hidden in the shadows, means it's time to work with your magic at Samhain. And so don't just focus on what you want. It's about what can be revealed, and take a time to commune with the ancestors and to honour those and to allow some of that fluid magic to come into your life as well. Well, I hope that helps you. I hope that helps you very much. Thank you so much for sending in your questions. Now, if you want to come through and have a more in-depth reading, you can. There are a number of different ways that you can get involved with us. You can come through to the website here, which is www.oracletelevision.com. Here you can find out how to book appointments with our featured guest psychics, and they're exclusive appointments. They're not always available 7 days a week. They are appointments that, you know, between your two schedules, we need to kind of find a space that works, and that's what we would do, and that would be over the telephone. But if you are a little bit more impatient, and that's completely fine, you can come through and have a reading on the phone right now, which is on 0207 193... Oh, it's not 193, it's 1116378. Oh, I've got myself caught out there with my numbers. 0207 1116378. That is the number to dial for a reading right now. So if you've been inspired by what I can do, what Tracy can do, what we can do together, you know, rest assured that the people that we are recommending on the phones can also do that to a high standard. I am very anti just kind of trying to sell you a hard sell all the time. So when I founded Oracle Television and this show, it was specifically to be showcasing psychics in the studio that I respected a great deal and I could work with very well. And I thought long and hard before associating with any off-screen psychics through a third-party company. But there is one company that I do have the utmost respect for, and I know over years of working in the industry that this company has a consistently high standard of people on their books, which is why I'm happy to recommend them. But again, I offer a prepay option here as well. I'm still not 100% sold on 0906 numbers for the time being. So if you dial 0207 111 6378, you can come through to a receptionist. You can find out who's available right now, and you can make an appointment with them, and you can rest assured that it will be good and it will be a high standard. And that's the only reason we've allowed them to be part of this show. There is another number on the screen here, and that's purely for making some appointments with Tracy. There'll only be a few, which is very exclusive.
Oh, yeah. I don't mean to be. It just works out that way. Exclusive is not what I hope to achieve, but it's just worked out that way.
And that number is is 0207 1936 64. I'm getting my numbers completely mixed up.
Give my own number out on mobile. I'm scared.
0207 1936 457. I mean, it's on the screen. You think I could read it?
Well, no, I wouldn't be able to read that from here. No, I think, I can't see those numbers.
Now, Tracy, it's now quarter past nine, and yes, you are going to be leaving us in about 15 minutes, aren't you? And so for the last part of the show, I'm going to be talking to you about some events that we've got coming up. But before you do go, can you tell me what you've got planned coming up in the next few weeks?
Well, I'm coming back here again.
Yeah.
I'm always looking for new ideas, new things to do. Obviously, I've got quite a full diary, both work and social.
Ooh, so what did you get up to?
Well, I've got sort of readings booked in and that. I'm also going bowling on Wednesday night for my sins, which really, I'm no good. I've only ever been once before, and I was a lot younger then, to bend and... But I'm dreading it. I've got to go. I always dread my fingers not, getting stuck in the holes in the ball and going down the... like that. I'm dreading it. But I'm going to go because I'm always telling people, try new things, enter into the spirit of things. I spend my life, or most of my life, going... You have to try these things. The universe is constantly moving and we should do the same. Yeah. Says me, who does exactly the same every day and every night and every... But, so I do try to practice what I preach. A few readings, booked in. I tend to get them sort of trickling in on a weekly basis because I do have sort of people who come regularly through to me. And then some just come out of the blue, contact me for a reading. So things like that. I did on Facebook a while ago, and that was actually quite a hard slog. You know what I was saying to you earlier about I have these wonderful ideas and I don't really, typical Aries, I'll do that. And then I realise it's going to wear me down like to nothing. And I actually did a card of the day on Facebook. And each day I use this deck with my own interpretation on Facebook. But I didn't think it took me months and it was every day. You cannot miss a day when you've got people waiting for that card and that interpretation. However, I've had a suitable rest. The wheels are already going round on what to do next.
Okay.
But I don't think it's going to be a daily thing because that really was a little bit overambitious because I knew people were expecting it. And you think people are going to remember the day you didn't do.
Yeah.
When you do sort of 78 cards. It doesn't matter. People are always... I actually also had them queued up ready to load up onto Facebook if I was ill. So I could just come ping.
Have you not heard of Hootsuite?
What? Clearly not.
No, Hootsuite is something that you can subscribe to, or you can even use it for, well, actually the subscription one is the one that would suit you. It doesn't cost very much money, but you can schedule your posts on Facebook. So you could go on one day and you could load them all up.
And it'll...
And you'd set
the schedule. See, I could have done that. But did they have it... How long's that been out?
Quite a while.
Oh, yeah, but I'm from... Not quite north of the Watford...
From
not London. So it's do you know what that is? No.
Okay, we'll have a little word later.
Yes. I'm trying to think of what else I can do.
Yeah.
Something different. So many people have done weekly horoscopes and tarot scopes and I'm still got a few ideas running around.
I feel if we could have a combination of your skills with your humour, it almost like a little blog would be fun.
I am in the process of getting a blog ready to... because even when I went on holiday a week ago, I have to write, don't put my whole life story on there, but certain things that happened could only happen to me. Like leaving a shop through a glass door and it wasn't a door. I mean, Who else would do that? And well, the owner goes, that's not the door. But I think he said it a little bit too late. And I think that was nasty, because I'd gone home.
Well, you went through a glass window.
You didn't break it, but I...
You yeah. just crashed it.
Yeah. And so things like that sort of seemed to happen to me. Like, I thought the barman was Spanish and he wasn't. And I was doing, like, no ice. And I found out he was English. I felt really silly.
I think going on holiday with you must be an absolutely hilarious thing.
And people said to me, do you know what? I waited for your... While you were on holiday, I waited for your Facebook postings. Yeah. And this is where it just comes from.
They wanted to know what happened when you had the cocktail at happy hour.
What happened when there was the snake at the exotic night and I ran through the restaurant. And they said, go outside, and I went outside, and then they brought it outside, so I had to run back through the restaurant and the reception. I was, like, throwing children and pensioners behind me as I was running out. And, I mean, I know that's not particularly spiritual, but they should say that they've got exotic night with birds, but they didn't have a picture of this great big yellow python. That was, as I walked outside the restaurant, it was in the bar. No, I mean, I'm frightened of them. It's just got my brandy, and I said, this is not on. No, but I don't like them. I said, it's your round. No, I actually don't like them at all, and I ran off. And then they said, go outside and wait, it won't come out, and then they brought it out. So I ran off again. So these things were happening to me while I was trying to have a week off. And so I think I will start writing a blog, because I do like... I write for your magazine, don't I? But seriously, for your magazine, I'm the agony aunt. And I won't laugh when people have got a problem.
No.
You know, I will deal with that properly. But I think with the writing, I do like it. And things just seem to happen to me. I mean, I've got a boring little life, really, and things happen to me out of the blue. So I think writing and the blog is next.
Yes, absolutely. Because you're making me cry.
I think I will write a blog. But it's got to be spiritual and psychic and to do with... I think I might publish my diaries one day. They might be a winner, actually, to be honest. Just things that happened.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I've kind of working on one myself as well, ever since we were working together in Milton Keynes. But the thing is, it's so risque that I can't actually publish it.
Really?
Yeah.
Do it under a...
Oh, no, come on, everyone's going to know.
Oh, God, that's Carrie that's wrote
that. Yeah,
it's
exactly.
Even funnier, isn't it?
The thing is, the psychic industry is small enough. Somebody already tried that and, you know, pretended it was not, it wasn't them. It didn't work. Everyone knew.
No.
You may as well just be honest and go, look, I wrote this. This is what I think, you know. But I think it's so risque that to really exploit the humour of it all and to sort of, like, I can embellish it, obviously make it fantastical. I think it's a little bit too close to the nerve while I'm still in the middle of the industry. Do you
see
what I mean?
Yeah, maybe. Just leave that for your old age,
It's in a way I feel as though more time needs to pass.
Right.
Because I think, you know, when this person did something before, it was quite raw, it was quite fresh. They wrote about people that they were still working
still
with.
Still working.
And they were still doing it. And obviously, you know, people in the psychic industries can be quite... eccentric and quite larger than life. Apart from us, we're totally normal.
Well, I think sometimes
what
people forget, we aren't any people.
Yeah, exactly.
And we do
But everybody's sensitive, and I think that if you ridicule people who are just a little bit sort of out of the ordinary, it's a little bit harsh.
It's not very nice, that, isn't it? It's horrible, actually.
Yeah. But I think that maybe if enough time passes, you can then bring it out and kind of keep revising and revising and making it into more fictional. So it's a long way removed from the original characters. And then I think even if people did recognise themselves a little bit, they'd just go, oh, well, you know. But you've got to leave enough, I think you've got to leave enough time. You've got to be gentle,
absolutely,
too.
And I think sometimes, you know, I mean, I can take a joke, if you like, but some people, it hurts them.
Yeah.
And not everybody's the same.
No.
And the reaction that you get, I mean, I think, oh, that's Carrie wrote. Look what she wrote about me.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah.
But some people it really hurt.
Yeah.
They would maybe even stop working.
No, exactly.
Because of it.
Yeah.
And you can't.
The thing
you know,
is, I would hate to be. I like and celebrate the fact that I know weird and wonderful people in the world. And I celebrate the fact that, you know, it can find common ground in what seems to be the most weird and wonderful, fantastical situations. And you know, maybe you stay with those people and maybe you don't, but I don't think it's fair to deride.
No, I don't either.
I think it's, you know, the pleasure of being able, the blessing of being able to enter into some weird and wonderful situations and see the world through other people's eyes, as far off the wall as it might be for that period of time or not, it's something to be treasured because it's what makes us who we are.
Yes.
It's just to be able to encourage that eccentricity and that creativity and that weird and wonderfulness, especially in the spiritual world.
Absolutely.
You know? So I think that, you know, and a lot of things have been coming through to me even recently that keeps referring to Tom Sharp, you know, that novelist.
Yes.
I keep going into situations, and the amount of times I've found myself going, oh, this is just like a Tom Sharp novel, it's just like a Tom Sharp novel. And sometimes I'm speaking to people that are quite a bit younger than me and they're going, who?
Yeah.
Like, oh God, I'm old.
I'm always doing that though.
but it's sort of, obviously there's an element, I think I need to go back and reread some of the Tom Sharp novels to kind of get this perspective, because it could be that this story can come out through that channel.
Yes.
But again, I feel it's so important to keep going back, and if anybody was in it, I'd discuss it with them first. Actually, I wouldn't pretend.
No.
I just think, what's to be gained? You know, you might as well go and talk to people and just,
yeah.
If you get them on side, maybe you can even get them to contribute.
Yeah, and put a bit more in.
Yeah, but you can combine all these characters and create them into something else. So I think that ultimately the point that I'm making here is that we can be in our circumstances and find ourselves going, oh, there's now it's so strange as folk and you couldn't make it up and this is just like way off the wall. But this is a pleasure and a blessing to even be able to have that in our lives. And it's not to be sort of disrespected in many ways, and it is important to be gentle and to be kind.
I think it is, because not everybody can take it.
Yeah.
And we sometimes, it's like you hit the nail on the head with seeing it from the other person's point of view.
Yeah.
Just because one person can take it on the chin, well, I did, as you know earlier.
Yeah.
Not, you know, I have to bring that up again.
You're not going to let that go,
no,
are you,
not
Tracy?
At all. Like, metaphorically speaking.
I accidentally
punched me in the face.
I was adjusting her microphone and my hand slipped and suddenly.
But some people like it, are sort of more hardy than others. Some people can take the criticism or the.
She used to work in a law firm. I should really be really worried. You're not going to let it go, are you?
I'll be getting up. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. I wonder if the person I work for still. I've still got their
personal
number.
Personal injury claim.
Yeah, I wonder if they're still there. I could give them a call tomorrow. And I think everybody, you've seen it from another person's point of view. Just because one person won't mind doesn't mean another one. Somebody else might have a fit.
Yeah.
And it really, you know, could like.
And no matter how emotive we feel at the time, how driven we feel is, I think that we can always really afford to try to take a little bit of time out. Just to say, well, hang on a minute, you know, am I happy with this course of action, with this attitude? How does the other person feel? You know, and then maybe you might come back and go, yeah, it's time for me to go ahead. I'm sorry, I don't care if you don't like it, I've got to do this. But, you know, all too often we steam in and we're not considering the other people's point of view, and then we get all upset at their repercussions and everything and things
like
that.
Well, there's going to everything, like the old saying, every action has a reaction.
Yeah.
And it's just about, you know, you've got to pitch the timing.
Yeah.
So that you don't get, you know, timing's everything, really.
Yeah.
And somebody who might sort of kill you today, like you say, might be okay with it in a couple of years' time.
Yes, absolutely.
They might think, oh, that's hilarious, that is.
Yeah, exactly.
But at the moment, there might be so much other stuff going on in their life that this could be the last straw.
Yeah, exactly.
And it's just about getting it right, isn't it, really?
Inflammatory, don't be inflammatory. Yeah. Well, Tracy, it's almost 9:30.
I
want to say a huge thank you for you coming into the studio. I know you've got to go off and get your train.
And I've got my train.
And we're going to be going to a break quite soon. And after that break, I'm going to be talking about some events that we've got coming up leading up to the Halloween period. Now, if you would like to book a reading with Tracy, she is going to be available for some select appointments by dialing 02071936457. You can come through and speak to us and we can make an appointment with you. Or just go through to the website. She's going to be on there by tomorrow morning, and that's www.oracletelevision.com. Now, we're going to go to a break in just a moment. If you'd like to have a reading right now, you can dial 02071116378. We're just going to go to a break for about 5 minutes or so. or 3 minutes even, 3 minutes or so. And after that break, I'm going to be back talking to you about some of the events and the exciting things that we've got coming up with Oracle Television over the next couple of weeks. So don't go anywhere, and I shall see you soon.
Hello and welcome to the Mind Body Soul Experience 2014. We've got a full programme of workshops throughout the day, two workshop rooms dedicated to all of our teachers, bringing you everything you need to know. And we've got a full programme of performances on our stage with music and chakras and meditation. So it's going to be really exciting. So if you'd like to come along and see us, we'd love to meet you. We're really pleased that there's something for everyone. So for those people who want to listen to someone talking about the things that they're really passionate about or they really really know a lot about, we've got people giving lectures. We've got interactive workshops and demonstrations where people can do guided meditation and that kind of thing. And obviously we've got lots of exhibitors here who want to show you that they've got lots of products available. One of the things I really love about Mind, Body, Soul is the atmosphere. That first morning when the doors open, or just before the doors open, and everyone's getting ready and you can just feel the excitement. It's a chance to make new friends and it's a chance to meet up with old friends, and it's just a really great atmosphere. Come along, have a look around, visit all of our exhibitors, and then pop down to the Om Yoga Show. Your ticket gets you in for free. If you'd like to come along and be part of this amazing show, just go online and buy a ticket now. Tickets are cheaper online than they are on the door, and if you want to buy a 2 or 3 day ticket, you'll make great savings. So go online and book your ticket now. It's going to be an amazing weekend and we can't wait to see you.
We thrive on social media as it means that we can talk directly with you, our viewers, all across the world. Please like, follow and share our posts and help us to spread the word about our broadcasts. It's as simple as that.
Good evening and welcome to eye-opening news from Oracle Television. My name's Carrie Kirkpatrick and I've got some juicy news for you coming up for this month of October. First of all, I'd like to tell you about the Mind, Body, Soul exhibition, a massive mind, body, soul and yoga exhibition in Olympia on the 24th, 25th and 26th of October. Oracle Television are going to be there. We launched there this time last year And this year we have a lovely stand there, stand number 24, and we are hosting a studio right in the event. Yes, that's right. Oracle TV are going to be filming and broadcasting directly from the Mind, Body, Soul exhibition and yoga show in Olympia. So do come down and see us at stand 24. Perhaps you'd like to come and be interviewed. Perhaps you'd like to come and see some of our celebrities who are being interviewed on our stand. Stand 24, that's the place to be. Also, coming a little bit further on in the month, on the 30th of October, coming up the night before Halloween, the Pagan Federation are hosting an open ritual, a Samhain ritual. It's always the event of the year. It's in Conway Hall in Red Lion Square, the place that we also held our evening of mediumship earlier on in the year. It's being hosted by Sarita de Esther and the Covenant of Hecate. It promises to be a good one. Get there early because it will be packed. It only costs about £5 to get in. Get there for 7 o'clock. It's going to be an incredible group ritual, an amazing social evening. So we hope to see you there. Now, another thing that's been coming up a lot recently in the news is a lot of anger amongst pagans and witches about the use of the name ISIS in the news when referring to the Islamic State terrorists. Now, we try not to get too involved with politics here at Oracle TV, but people who are involved in paganism, especially the Fellowship of ISIS, of course, I'm a priestess of the Fellowship of ISIS, and other businesses with the name ISIS have been enraged that her name has been used in this context. ISIS is, of course, an Egyptian goddess that is revered by many, many people and has got nothing to do with terrorism or atrocities. And for too long, the media kept referring to the terrorist group as ISIS instead of ISIL, or now they're calling it IS, which we're very pleased about. So thank goodness all that pressure that's been put on the media has actually worked. And I think the Huffington Post led the way. So thank you very much to the Huffington Post. Now, don't forget that Grant Collier and Sam EB Psychic are going to be hosting Becoming Psychic radio show this Thursday evening, as they do every Thursday night. It's going to be featuring amazing guests, free readings by Grant Collier. And we had him on the Spirit Show just a couple of weeks ago, and everyone who is watching knows just how good he is. So do stay tuned, follow them on Facebook and listen in on their radio show on Thursday night. The Saulnier Society have got an incredible event coming up in New Battle Abbey in Scotland. Now, this promises to be a great event with esoteric researchers, historians giving fantastic lectures. Oracle TV are going to be there, and we're going to be filming this event this time in this incredible New Battle Abbey, this location. I've wanted to go there for years, so we're really looking forward to that. If you'd like to come and join us, just look up the Saulnier Society online and book yourself in. Now, we've also got two special shows coming up for you on Oracle TV. Do join us over the Halloween period. We've got a Halloween special on Sunday, the 2nd of November. We're going to be looking at the history of the Witch's Coven, the sacred space in Queenswoods, where we've filmed a lot of rituals, we've taken part in a lot of rituals, and looking into the history behind this incredible location. We've also got a new series being launched just after Halloween, and that's Beyond the Veil, Past Lives Revealed, featuring Francesca McDonald, incredible international psychic medium, in a series of programs looking at past lives, why you should look at them, what they mean to you, and how you can work with them to great effect. Stay tuned and we'll see you soon. I'm Carrie Kirkpatrick, and I'd like to welcome you to the world of goddess enchantment, magic and spells. These books aren't just for the experts amongst you, these are also for beginners, those who just wish to explore the psychic world, the spiritual world, the pagan world. There's a little bit of something for everybody in Goddess Enchantment, Magic and Spells, Volumes 1 and 2.
In Volume 1, we deal with the pagan Wheel of the Year. Now, even though this has Celtic origins, we have also included goddesses from different pantheons, and we've created beautiful pictures along with visualizations and spells, and some history about each goddess. In Volume 2, we deal specifically with goddesses of love, abundance, and transformation. Not everyone can have a statue of their favourite goddess for their altar, so the idea of these photographs is that you can use them as a focal point on your altar. You can place the candles in front of them, make offerings, place the flowers, and sit and meditate on these images and get a connection to the goddesses by practicing the visualizations and the rituals detailed in the books. You can also download the pictures of the goddesses onto your iPad or Kindle and use that as a digital altar as well. So this is a very modern way of working with the goddesses, and you can have an altar wherever you may be in the world. As a psychic, I have worked with people for many, many years who like to develop their own spiritual and psychic abilities. And what does that actually mean? Many people do actually like to learn how to meditate, to connect with their higher self, to connect with a certain something other. And why is that? Because they want to learn more about themselves, maybe to understand what they're going through in their lives, to improve themselves. And that also leads us into the area known as cosmic ordering, focusing their will, their wishes, on manifesting that which they want in their lives. The results speak for themselves, and there's a general feel-good factor after doing these kind of meditations. Try it for yourself.
That's it. Hello and welcome back to Psychic Oracle Live. My name is Carrie Kirkpatrick, and in this section of the show, I'm going to be teaching you a little bit about magic. Yes, that's right. What we have here is a symbol, or simplified version, if you like, of a symbol, which is called a veve. And this relates to a deity called Papalegba. Now, why am I going to do this? Well, because we're fast approaching a time of year when magic and witchcraft and supernatural is a lot more in people's focus. It comes a lot more to the forefront because we are fast approaching the time of Halloween. Now, pagans and people who follow a more ancient Celtic calendar wouldn't call it Halloween. They call it Samhain. And there are many different traditions, many associations, even from different cultures across a large part of the world, which do relate to ceremonies at this time of year. There's a common thread that runs through quite a lot of these cultures, and that is that it's a time of year to honour those that have died, those that have passed away. And they say that the veil between the two worlds is at its thinnest at this time of year. So Halloween, 31st of October, which is coming up, is a time often regarded as a good time to maybe light a candle, meditate on those that have passed over, that are in spirit. Even if you're not naturally mediumistic and sensitive, you can still honour them, send out a message, quite possibly receive a sense of closeness or a message from them as well. If you are mediumistic or psychic, you know this is a very potent time, psychically, magically, spiritually, on all those levels, when all the receptors are really going. And if you're into your witchcraft and your paganism and the different traditions in neo-pagan revival, you may also find that this is a very busy time with lots of ceremonies, lots of activity, lots of things going on. Because for pagans, this is really New Year. It's the end of the year and the beginning of the new year. So it's a very important celebration, the most important celebration of the whole year. What can you do with it in terms of self-development, in terms of personal magic? Well, you can do a lot. As I've already said, you can honour those that have gone before and give your respects to the ancestors. And even people who are not pagans and psychics are doing this not long afterwards, with Remembrance Sunday, with Armistice Day, you've got the Mexican Day of the Dead, etc., etc. There's many traditions doing this. But on a personal level, if you want to do your own personal magic, I say this is a good time to really look at what you want to release from your life, what is done, what is concluded, what you want to release from your world, and also then start to bring in new things. So you see the parallel there with what other people would associate with New Year's Eve, making those New Year's resolutions. So for pagans, we would do this at Samhain. Now, why have I brought Papalegba in here? Well, he is a voodoo lover, and even though he's not traditionally associated with Samhain, we did incorporate him into a big public ritual that we hosted in Queenswoods a few years ago, and that was to honour Samhain, and it was a creative interpretation of different traditions and references, and all brought together into a theatrical interactive performance set in the woods with a cast of about 30 people and an audience of about 150. And Papa Legba was there in his role as the gatekeeper. He's the gatekeeper in the voodoo tradition. So you can't really communicate with any of the other loa or the deities within the voodoo tradition without going to Papa Legba first, because he's the gatekeeper. He brings them through. Now, for me personally, I've actually just liked working with Papa Legba over the years. He's been my primary deity to connect with in that tradition, as well as Goddess Urzuli as well. But mainly Papa Legba, and he's a bit of a dude, really. I recently did a ritual invoking him and Hecate, the goddess of the crossroads, at the same time for the Pagan Federation, and brought through a triple aspect crossroads with a four-way crossroads in the same path working and ritual for some very well-experienced pagans from different traditions. And it worked. It's a very accessible magic, and you can afford to be quite creative with it. Obviously, there are parts of the world that he's worked with as an active religion, part of an active religion even today, and he has different names in different parts of the West Indies and the South American states, from Elugua to Papa Legba to Esu to Eshu. There's a darker aspect of the voodoo traditions and there's a lighter aspect of the voodoo traditions. There are two separate strands. I've always only ever worked with the lighter one and worked mainly with the aspect called Papa Legba and Elugua together. They're quite close. Now, this is what we call a veve, and traditionally this would be drawn on the floor, usually out of corn flour, and it's an intricate symbol. Usually we'd have a few other things here, like a kind of a walking stick and maybe a sword and a few other flourishes, and this would be a way of honouring the loa, and it would form part of the altar and the ceremony to call them in. This one was created for us by a dear friend called Ian Crowther, when we did the public ritual, and we needed something that was a little bit simplified, something very physical that we could work with, that we could host in the actual magical circle that we were working with, which is outdoors in Queenswoods, and as I said, with an attendance of about 200 people. It's also got fluorescent paint on here as well, which was very useful as it got dark during the ceremony and people were able to see where the gate was to leave the circle by. I also have here a beautiful wooden hand-carved, very old goblet here with an African male face on it that, as soon as I saw it in Atlantis Bookshop, the occult bookshop, many years ago, I just knew that this was a Papa Legba cup. To be fair, if you try to drink out of it as time's gone by, I've had it for about 15 years, it's got a big crack down the side, and if you put the rum in it for Papa Legba, you'll find that it does actually sort of drip all the way down and sort of ends up going all over his face, strangely enough. So he gets to drink it more than you do, which is quite appropriate, I think. And I think that this wood now is quite well soaked and steeped in rum. Although it's not really the best drinking vessel, it's more an element of devotion here. So you might think, well, why would I want to work with Papa Legba, a god of the crossroads like that? And I say, well, it's because if you're kind of exploring magic as a way of achieving some results and bringing about change in your life, he's a very good deity to work with. You know, you can go and kind of experience and make a connection and see how you like the vibration, like the feeling of it. And if you don't want to do any more, that's absolutely fine. There's no commitment. But for many people, he's very accessible. And as I said, he's a bit of a dude. When we did the event at the Pagan Federation, I asked everybody afterwards what they'd picked up in their visualizations, bearing in mind that they'd all done quite a lot of visualizations over the years. And it transpired that, to their surprise, about 8 of the women sort of said, well, he sort of came up to me and sort of was really flirtatious or kissed me or made a comment about my bum and stuff like that. And they were quite shocked and said, is this normal? And I had to laugh because really, these are the kind of attributes you might associate with him because he's a bit cheeky. They're going, he's a bit cheeky. What did he say that for? So anyway, we had a good old giggle about that. When you're working with him, you would tend to offer rum and a cigar, and sometimes chocolate coconut sweets. And also 3 copper coin can be offered at the crossroads as well. If you're asking for a wish, you're asking for something to happen. If you don't have copper coin, just have a little something else, and that's fine as well. So in my Pagan Federation ritual, I had lots of, because I didn't know how many people were going to be there, and it was very well attended, I had lots of little gold belly dancing coins that would be sewn onto costumes, so everyone was able to work with them and kind of put them on the altar and put them on for other people as well. So I think that you'll find really that when you're working with these deities, you can afford to slightly reinvent some of the traditions and to work with them in a way that seems appropriate to you. It's not going to matter if you couldn't find dark room, you could only find light. It doesn't matter if you didn't get a cigar one time. So I think that really what you can do when you're working with him is come through and actually make a connection and ask for something that you want. Remember, he's the god of the crossroads, the god of communications, of justice, and he can bring about some fast results really quite quickly. And what we're going to be doing after Halloween is we're going to start producing and releasing some paper download tutorial videos, which are really giving you step-by-step rituals and techniques that you can practice and develop. And really kind of give us feedback as well. This isn't something that you just have to do on your own in isolation. You can also kind of get in touch, say what's happening, how you're finding your meditations and your exercises, and we will help you to grow and expand in the skills and the knowledge as we're going forward. And so really what I'd like you to do is just stay in touch with us, stay tuned. After Halloween, we're going to be bringing you some of this information. But we're going to go to a short break now, and after we come back, I'm going to tell you what's coming up in the next 2 weeks. So we'll see you soon.
Good evening and welcome to Oracle TV's Halloween special. My name's Carrie Kirkpatrick and I'm currently standing in Queen's Woods in Highgate, an affluent North London suburb. I'm standing in an area known as the Witch's Coven, surrounded by 13 oak trees with the addition of holly and rowan. This area has been sacred for many, many years as witches have gathered here and conducted many rituals, myself included. Why is it that this woods remains undeveloped, with the price of land being what it is? It's because it is protected, and it is sacred, and it is also the site of a plague pit. What lies at the heart of this wonderful woods, with its mystical, magical energies? If you want to find out more, stay tuned to Oracle TV.
Hello and welcome back to Psychic Oracle Live. I'm sorry I'm laughing, it's because we've just had cats taking over the asylum. They had to be forcibly removed, they had to call security. Really? I swear, they're going to have their own show one time. You're tuning in, you're going, oh, what's this new show Carrie's putting out? And Carrie's not here, so it's going to be the cats. So if they do that, I'm just saying, now, don't give them any money, okay? Now, welcome back to Psychic Oracle Live. We're here with you for another 10 minutes. And I'd like to tell you what's coming up in the next couple of weeks. Now, this coming few days, I can't believe it's so soon, we're going to be at the Mind Body Soul exhibition in Olympia, the Mind Body Soul Experience, and that's with the Om Yoga Show as well. It's an absolutely massive event with up to 27,000, oh, that's the wrong way around, up to 27,000 people attending over 3 days. So if you come down to Olympia on the 24th, the 25th and the 26th of October, you can come down and find us in the Mind Body Soul Experience and the Om Yoga Show. We're on stand 24. What are we doing? Well, it's very exciting. For the first time, we're hosting a pop-up TV studio in the middle of the event. That means that we're going to be interviewing exhibitors, interviewing speakers, interviewing celebrities that are attending the event. And also, we're going to be interviewing you. So if you come down to the event and you'd like to take part, we've got quite a busy schedule filling up already. Come to Stand 24. Find out if, you know, if you've just been to a workshop, or if you've just had a reading with somebody, you've just had a healing with somebody. Come and talk to us. Come and tell us how was your experience. Tell us how much you're loving the event. We're doing this in conjunction with the organisers, and we're really excited to be able to do so. A couple of years ago, we'd attended the Mind, Body, Soul experience and filmed interviews with people on their actual stands. And last year, we were there actually launching Oracle Television. So it's really close to our heart to be able to go back there this year and host a TV studio within the middle of the event. So come and find us, Stand 24. It's about being interactive. It's about giving you some audience participation. So if you want to come and get on that camera, just tell us what you think. You know, tell us, you know, what you'd like to do. You know, we're here to promote other businesses within the spiritual industry. We're here to create commercials. We're here to create shopping programs as well, because shortly after the Mind, Body, Soul experience, we're going to be starting to work on our new shopping program as well. And our first shopping program will be available before Christmas. We're going to do a Christmas special. So if you're watching now and you've got some lovely spiritual products that you'd like to sell on our shopping program, do get in touch with us. Just come through on the website, oracletelevision.com, or phone us on 0207 193 6457. Come through and speak to me. We're looking for some contributors, people with some really interesting, spiritually inspiring products to sell. And we're looking for actual things for this show, okay? So it could be your own range of essences that you've created, oils, it could be your own candles, lovely, beautiful, magical cloaks, or your own books. Or it could be something else that you've created. You know, come through. If you think that having a spiritual shopping channel is exactly what you've been looking for to sell your products, come through for our Christmas special. We're going to be recruiting people over the Mind, Body, Soul experience, and also shortly afterwards, and actually shortlisting our contributors in the first 2 weeks of November. So if you want to be involved, you know what to do. But in the meantime, just come down and see us, because we're so excited to be there at Olympia hosting this studio and filming with all these lovely people that are gathered there for these 3 days. Does it stop there when we come back? Do we get to have a rest? No, we don't, because we're going to be really busy all the way through up until Halloween. Now, we're already going to the Pagan Federation event, as you've seen in our news bulletin, on the 30th of October. And we'd love you to come and join us. It's in Conway Hall in Red Lion Square in London, in Holborn. And it starts at 7:30. And you can come down. Sarita De Esther is hosting the Pagan Federation Samhain Ritual. And it's going to be fantastic. It's going to be an amazing night. As I said, this is like the Pagan New Year. So if you want to come down and be part of a really highly charged, magical Hecate ritual at Samhain, like that, just the day before Halloween, come down and take part. But do remember to join us on Sunday, the 2nd of November, because this is our Halloween special. Please accept our apologies that it's not on Friday, the 31st of October, but it's such a busy night for everybody concerned that we just really couldn't fit it in on the Friday. So we're sticking with our Sunday slot, because we know a lot of you are more available to watch us live. It's going to be a live show, and it's going to be 4 hours, but the way we're going, it might even extend to 5, okay? But we've got guests coming in. We're looking specifically at the Witch's Coven, that sacred area in Queenswoods that we've done rituals with, we've talked about, you've seen the trailers. Well, we're making a film purely about that, and we're talking to some magical practitioners who've worked in that circle extensively over, well, ever since the 1970s. I found out some information from some of our interviewees that is just mind-blowing, and I was really surprised because I didn't know that. And yet it still survives today as a place where people go, celebrate magical ritual, and even children come and refer to it as the Witch's Coven on their children's parties and sit in a little fairy circle and have their own new generation of magic and make-believe happening. And that unfolded for us right before our very eyes yesterday when we were doing some filming. So it's absolutely beautiful to watch. We've also got David Farrant coming into the studio talking about the history, the magical supernatural history of the Queenswoods and the Witch's Coven area, and also talking about the Highgate vampire, for which he is famous, a story that he's been deeply involved with for many, many years. We've got Nathaniel coming in, Nathaniel Adams coming in from the Pagan Federation to talk to us about the Pagan Federation, what they're doing for people, why they're hosting Samhain rituals and talking also about other celebrations throughout the year. And from the Wiccan perspective, what Samhain means to him as a growing religion today. We're going to be joined by an incredible psychic who's also a witch, Seldi Bate, who has numerous years experience working as a professional psychic but also as a witch, and she's going to be giving us her take on Samhain, Halloween, and answering some of your questions that you're sending in interactively throughout the show. We've also got interviews with Sarita De Esther and Ken Reese, Gareth Medway, and much more. Not to mention some very supernatural tales about curses and Halloween period from Francesca McDonald, Celtic witch and 8th generation healer. So it's going to be an amazingly supernatural, spooky night, but with a lot of reality in there. We're getting real with what's behind all of this magic, and we'd really like you to come and join us. Now, we've just got a couple of minutes left of the show, and I'm really glad that you were able to join us tonight. Thank you so much for getting involved, for sending in your questions. We've had such a laugh. I mean, there are times when you could see I was like crying because Tracy just had me in fits, and I was trying not to have my makeup all down my face. But, you know, she really was an amazing guest, and she's now winging her way home. But do make sure that you tune in, join us on Halloween. It's going to be a 4-hour show at the moment. If it runs over time, it may very well be 5 and we'll just start a bit earlier. But stay tuned, follow us on Facebook, stay in touch with all the updates. And don't forget, everything is available to view on YouTube and on our website after the event as well. So thank you so much for joining us. Remember, if you want to have a reading, it's 0207 111 6378. Come through to our website at any time, www.oracletelevision.com. And if you wanted to book that reading with Tracy, it's 0207 193 6457. That's me signing off for tonight, Carrie Kirkpatrick. Thank you very much for being with us, and I look forward to seeing you in a couple of weeks.
Good evening and welcome to Oracle TV's Halloween special. My name's Carrie Kirkpatrick and I'm currently standing in Queen's Woods in Highgate, an affluent North London suburb. I'm standing in an area known as the Witch's Coven, surrounded by 13 oak trees with the addition of holly and rowan. This area has been sacred for many, many years as witches have gathered here and conducted many rituals, myself included. Why is it that this woods remains undeveloped, with the price of land being what it is? It's because it is protected, and it is sacred, and it is also the site of a plague pit. What lies at the heart of this wonderful woods, with its mystical, magical energies? If you want to find out more, stay tuned to Oracle TV.